Don't you feel like you can continue to not get them, though? Isn't that like the inverse galaxy?
You know what's
brain?
Funny? Honestly, you know what? People self-censor when it comes to that stuff. But I feel like it's a waste of time.
We get to iron out the kinks before tomorrow.
Fuck yeah, we do. Ain't no kinks. Except we're in the bedroom.
Alright. I don't know how I knew you were going there, too.
Bruh.
The second you said
that. If you ever wonder if I'm gonna say, if you ever wonder which way it's gonna go, it's always gonna be dirty jokes. Always.
I'll keep that in mind. I'll tee you up.
Always the
gutter. I'm gonna tee you up all weekend.
Alright, alright, alright. It's not just me, though. You got to get these dirty jokes, too. Like, tomorrow, the grimier, the better.
The grimier, the better. That's part of the the atmosphere you're
yes,
going for, right?
Yes, thank the you. Grimiest. You ain't got to worry about pulling no punches.
It's because it's the anti-esports club, right?
You know what? Yeah, that's right. You know why? You can't lose any sponsors if you ain't got none.
Don't you feel like you can continue to not get them, though? Isn't that like the inverse galaxy?
You know what's
brain?
Funny? Honestly, you know what? People self-censor when it comes to that stuff. But I feel like it's a waste of time to self-censor when you ain't even really in the conversation. Because every time I have those conversations with sponsors, they never ever say, oh, well, do we got to keep it PG? It never even comes up.
That's a good point.
Never.
Are we live already, or is this just...
Oh, okay. Oh,
oh
shit.
Damn,
all
right.
Live. Hey, all right, welcome
I'm gonna hit
everybody.
Tweet button.
Yes.
Send this shit out.
Welcome, everybody. It is day two of PAX East. We are here at Balance Patch in Boston, Massachusetts. My name is gootecks, and I'm joined here by Brad Muse, who is one of the Northeast FGC regulars.
Yep.
And Brad, thank you so much for having me.
No, man. Thank you for coming. Thank you for bringing all the attention and everything that's been going on this weekend. I know you're up here for PAX. I know you're
guys,
up here for bar fights tomorrow. You're up
you
here
guys,
tonight for Jazzy Circuit.
You guys and Lucky D have been building that hype. I'm just here. I'm just passing through. I'm just here in town.
Yep,
you guys have been doing the work.
Well, you're here in town for Jazzy Circuit tonight because the Jazzy
that's
Circuit
right.
was kind enough to come through tonight.
That's right. Yes. So Jazzy Circuit, Third Strike, Old Man Games. 21 years of Third Strike, and he was here somewhere.
Is it 21 years already?
1999.
Jesus.
Feel old yet?
Wow. It's before my time in the scene, but not before my time playing
games.
On
the planet?
Certainly not. No.
Ooh.
Well, wait, hold on. I have the rare opportunity for me not to feel old. I was...
What were
old?
You doing in 1999?
I was 7 years old, so...
Okay, let me tell you a story about Third Strike.
All right.
I borrowed my friend's Dreamcast. I didn't play... In 1999, I didn't play Third Strike in the arcade. I mean, maybe I played it... I didn't play it seriously. I didn't have,
okay.
like, time, right? I borrowed my friend's Dreamcast, and I used to play at... the home of the girl that I lost my virginity to.
Wait, are you telling me you rolled through? You played some Street Fighter 3.
Third strike, yeah. Yeah. Third, yeah.
And then triple tapped.
Triple tapped.
Before Netflix and chill, there was gootecks doing Street Fighter 3.
This was so long ago. Obviously, shit, like, it wasn't... Okay, see, here, nowadays... One could conceivably have a situation in which you could be like, yeah, I play fighting games. And a girl would be like, you know, and be like, yeah, I'm pretty good at fighting games. In 2020, that could theoretically be something where a girl would be like, oh, really?
I'm going with in 99, that was not the case.
No. No. That was not the case.
Color me shocked.
Yeah, I know. Imagine that. So I'm just saying, you're welcome.
Yes, because you laid the groundwork, you laid the foundation.
I Yes. Yeah. I laid the groundwork. Yeah. Okay. You know what? Yeah, I did lay the groundwork. You know what? Yeah, I laid the groundwork so that future generations, PAX 2030.
Get that dirt off your
shoulder. Right. PAX 2030. You're welcome.
2030, 10 years from now? That's how far we're looking in the future?
It's not that far. It's not that far. I saw, okay, look it. I was at PAX today. Did you go?
I was not there today. I'm there tomorrow.
Okay. All right. As you'll see tomorrow, there are lots of opportunities for a competitive fighting game player to, you know, play different games, try.
Every click.
Every frame.
Every press.
Every sound.
They're playing aggressive.
I'll take mid. Every advantage.
When the difference
between winning and losing
is measured in milliseconds.
Everything.
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 Everything counts.
The Alienware Legendary Battle Station.
Try out different games and be there and potentially someday attract some female attention.
Okay, I wasn't sure which direction you were taking that.
Always dirty.
So you said.
Always dirty.
So you
dirty,
said,
Brad.
I was like, yo, are we bringing it to sponsorships and the growing ability to make it? No. Gootecks and sponsorships are like, it's like this.
Look it. History will show that Gootecks and Mike Ross were some of the first fighting game players ever sponsored. Look it up. You don't believe me? Look it up. This is how I know the sponsorship game.
Well, how far back are you going with that? Are you going with, like, Complexity? Like,
yes.
How far back?
Yes.
Complexity
that
was,
counts.
That was, like, the second or third big player in the game, right? Like, it was
EG.
That's what
I'm saying. I didn't say I was the first. I said we were one of the first.
Yeah.
It was Justin.
Actually,
it was Marn.
Well, yeah, Marn.
It was actually Marn. Fun fact, Marn was the first fighting game player ever sponsored,
you
to my knowledge, in the history of
fighting games
and
esports. Marn, I was, I don't know, did you watch J.M. Crofts doing the FGC Jeopardy that he's been doing?
No, I've only seen his video about Champ and
KBR.
Yeah, Champ and KBR.
I still love that match.
I haven't seen it.
I still love that match.
It shows up. That's that. I've only seen that.
So he did. He's been doing an FGC Jeopardy thing with other FGC streamers.
Oh, put that one in there.
So it kind of was. I mean, not that specifically, but thinking about
prototypical sponsored FGC players for 500, Alex.
Well, so one of the things is it was like talking about Evo champions, and it was talking about Marn winning TVC.
Yep.
At
Marn
Evo
is an Evo
2010,
champion. Yep.
Because it was also the last year that Marvel 2 was there.
Until now.
That was the first Evo I really watched, if you want to feel old now.
The first Evo I really watched was 2003, which was the one I was there.
That wasn't Evo at the time still, was it?
That was the second year that it was Evo.
So you don't go as far back as the B series?
I do not.
I see.
I do not. Look, I'm OG. I'm not that OG.
It's a lowercase O.
That's right. And first year was 2003. I went because I was going to summer school.
Okay.
Because, newsflash, Gootecks was not the best student.
You were playing Street Fighter 3 on Dreamcast.
I was playing
Hanging
Third Strike on Dreamcast and the arcade because
house.
Cal Poly. No. This was 3 years later.
Okay. So you were playing too much fighting games and the girls weren't around anymore.
This was between 2001 and 2003. I was going to school at Cal Poly Pomona, and me and my friends, we would play Third Strike on Dreamcast as well as the Cal Poly Arcade. And then one day, my friend, because I was in summer school, my friend was like, yo, there's this really big Street Fighter tournament there at school, so since you're already there, you should go. And I was like, okay, cool. That sounds great. And I walked into Evo 2003, which was when it was still not on console. It was arcade.
Okay.
And I walked in, and I was like, this is incredible. I felt like I was home, even though I didn't know anybody.
Sure. Well,
I didn't know anybody.
It's that first moment, right, where you step into the room, and this thing that you've been loving on your own in the confines of your home, you discover that there's this whole world for it.
Well, here's the thing. I'm old enough to remember when GamePro Magazine would put out Street Fighter content, strategy guides, and I bought different books. Back in the day, there used to be printed physical guides. And
I remember for some reason buying the one for Marvel 3.
That's right. And Marvel 3 was way later. But Fighter 2, Champion Edition, Hyper Fighting, ST, there were physical guides.
And so what did
and
they
would
even
read
put
that.
In those?
They would put the combos and a little bit about each character. And then at the end, there would be like a little section about the tournament scene.
Okay.
And so I would read about guys like Alex Valle and Mike Watson and Jeff Schrader. I would read about them as a child. And then years later, I went to Cal Poly Pomona and stumbled across Evo. And I was blown away when I got there. Made one friend, Simon from Nebraska, because he was an Asian dude from Nebraska. And he was like, yo, is there any boba around here? And speaking of Third Strike, the game that has brought us here today, we are going to have our first match. It is going to be Jim versus Everdread, a man whose name I've only seen on the interweb.
I got to say, Everdread, without being...
I thought Everdread was Renny Player.
Okay, you would know far better than me, because I was about to say, Everdread sounds like the type of name of a guy that's playing Akuma.
Really?
That isn't Akuma player's name.
Okay, maybe I'm thinking of a different Everdread. Anyways, so, Brad, do you know anything about this game? It's okay if you don't.
I have a passing familiarity, but what I do know is, isn't Remy not particularly great?
Right, so, one could say that Akuma is upper mid-tier, and one could also say that generally Remy is considered to be pretty low on the tier list. I would say that most people consider Remy low on the tier list because he can do a decent job of zoning you out with the Sonic Booms, because he can do a high and low Sonic Boom, and he's got the EX Sonic Boom, and he's got that little kick there. But, you know, generally he has low health. Projectiles in general are not super effective in this game,
right,
in general, because of the
parry. Nullify that whole thing.
Yeah. And, you know, I don't expect anybody to know this because this game is more than 20 years old. But what I will say is that if it's your first time watching this game or you don't really know a whole lot about it, all you really need to know is that in this game, there's a difference between Third Strike players and every other Street Fighter player. Because Third Strike players believe that impossible is nothing.
Okay.
There is no situation. There is a tier list, but the reality is that if you are actually godlike, you have the capacity in this game, because of the parry mechanic, to be able to defeat literally anybody. Case in point, Kuroda. Arguably the strongest Third Strike player of all time, won SBO Super Battle Opera, which at the time was the most prestigious Japanese tournament on the planet. He won SBO with Q, who is considered by far the worst character in this game. He won that tournament, a 3v3 single elimination, tournament with Q. Now, how is that possible?
Godlike reads.
Yes.
Strictly being the best player in the room.
Yes, but also the parry mechanic levels the playing field. And this is why Third Strike players looked at Street Fighter 4 and were like, well, this is garbage. And this is why, you know, I don't know, maybe people who started playing 4 or started playing Street Fighter with Street Fighter 5, you know, they put so much emphasis on, what's the tier list and what does this character do? Whereas in Third Strike, it's just like, well, if I just know that you're going to do everything that you're going to do, it really doesn't matter what you do.
Right. That I feel the hell out of that. And that brings an interesting question. Given that you just remarked about Third Strike players' opinions of 4, but you obviously made such a footprint with content creation and bringing a lot of that stuff forward with 4.
Oh, well, yeah.
What did you feel that way about 4? Or did you feel that way at first and then find the appeal for it later?
Here's the thing. there are many instances in life where our feeling, our own personal feelings matter.
Okay.
And there are some instances in which it doesn't fucking matter what you think.
Okay.
And as a third strike player, there was so much that I loved and enjoyed about this game that was not present in 4.
Okay.
But the reality was, at the time, do I want to continue to pursue Street Fighter as a passion and try to take it to the next level in terms of content or competing or just sort of being relevant? And at the time, the answer was yes, I do want to do that. Therefore, it didn't really matter how I felt about 4.
I really like that answer.
So there was lots of, you know, there were lots of things about 4 that I liked and didn't like. And there were lots of things about Third Strike that I wish was in 4, but it wasn't there. But did that stop me? No, because my feelings didn't matter.
Right, but you know what does matter?
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Has partnered with so many different sponsors that will kick in for you instead of you paying that money.
It's free money.
Free,
I mean,
money
for our players,
for the
not
pot.
For you, but it's
That's
free
right.
money.
No, not for me. I don't care. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Not for
well,
me.
Well, I mean, for you if you win, I suppose, because you even entered tonight. You're playing
oh,
for those
right,
Jazzy
I did.
Points.
Oh, shit. You know what?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're only here with me so long as you're not hitting buttons, hitting the
you know what?
Setting
I could
up
be
the mirrors.
That's right. You know what? I could be a benefactor. Of the Matcherino.
You could get those points.
We probably shouldn't
that
say that. People
it's in
are
your
not
self-interest to plug that link.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing. It's in my self-interest to plug the Matcherino, regardless of my entrance, participation, and performance in Third Strike tonight. Because Matcherino is supporting our event, Bar Fights, tomorrow.
That's true.
And so if you buy tomorrow an anti-esports esports club through t-shirt through the Matcherino.
Do you still have the hoodie? You do still have the hoodie.
Through the Matcherino, then some of that money will go to the pot for tomorrow's.
Can you even see it? You managed to turn the sleeve inside out.
That's right.
There
for
you go.
Tomorrow's Armed Forces Street Fighter V tournament at Bar Fights.
Yeah, among other things.
Yes. Yes, which you can watch here. If you're watching on the CrossCounter TV channel, you can stay tuned right here. If you're watching on the Balance Patch channel and you're in the Boston area, we invite you to come to Bar Fights tomorrow. There's a special, if you go to barfights.crosscounter.tv, you can use coupon code Balance Patch, and we'll hook you up for mañana. But who do we have up next here?
Yeah, I think
I'm Street Fighter 3 Third Strike.
Take a second to pull up the bracket on my phone here so you can see what's going on. Maybe you're holding up the bracket, gootecks.
That might be me.
But what the hell? You guys
Thank
can't
you.
See it, but someone just handed this man some cold cuts
you
off,
know why?
Off the side of the stream.
Yeah.
Why?
He knows my preference. Look, carbs are the devil, okay?
What the hell
carbs,
does that mean?
Carbs are the devil. Look it. People don't like to hear it. Carbs
I don't
the
like
devil.
To hear it. Carbs
I
are
don't.
What I eat.
You're
as
welcome.
You can see.
You're welcome.
That's the
look
carbs,
it. Look
the
it.
Carbs
if
are
you
what
it,
taste
look
good.
I didn't say a word
and,
about
and,
taste.
And the meat.
I didn't say anything about taste. I didn't say about anything about taste. Bro, if I could just sit and eat ramen all day, every day,
That's what I would do. But at the end of the day, I'm trying to look good naked.
That's fair.
Don't you?
I'm married. It doesn't matter.
I would not take... I would not... This is your unsolicited marriage advice of the day? I would not say that a metal object on your finger is justification for letting go of the rest of your body.
No, that's fair. I need to...
Just saying.
Carbs taste good.
No argument. No argument here. I don't disagree.
To segue back to the tournament, I don't know what match we're going to get. I'm not positive yet, but I can tell you that you're going to be playing Everdread. Shoutouts to Bow. You did not.
I think she did.
I have to yell at her later.
Well, she's gone now.
Good?
Good riddance.
She
do that a lot?
No, she's never done that. I've never even seen her leave the counter. Because that is one of the Balance Patch employees who Balance Patch are kind enough to have us here every week. So
I talked to Peter.
Yeah, no, Peter's a great guy. They've been kicking around here for... Geez, has it been? It's 2 or 3 years now, I think?
I even told Peter. I even sort of led the conversation in a way in which I implied that fighting game people were the ones that were most down to come every week. Because when I was talking to him, he was like, yeah, you know, it's a little bit harder for people that play team games come all the time. And I was like, who would have thought? Yeah, FGC people putting in work week after week here at Balance Patch here in Boston, Massachusetts. Why? Because we leave the house. Coronavirus? Who cares?
Away from Vegas for you.
Yeah.
You had to get on a plane.
I actually came from L.A. by way of Vegas. I went from Vegas to L.A. and then I came here. Yes. Yes.
Crop dusting Cronas the whole time. That's Ken and right. Black versus Quan. Another Remy.
You never see this.
I was going to say, some shit
this
is
a rarity.
I did my homework before today and watched a bunch of Jazzy Circuit Third Strike. Nothing could have prepared me for two Remys on stream. I watched like 4 hours of footage. I saw one Remy.
Well, good news. You're not going to see him for too much longer because Quan looks like he is going to continue this domination. He is... Quan is the man behind the body pillow
stick. So, I can actually explain this.
What?
I didn't realize because I've actually never seen his handle because I just know him in real life. But did you see the picture, I think it was on Kappa, of the guy with the, like, the waifu body pillow that
was
he had made the
Cody?
Stick?
No,
it was
okay.
like a waifu body pillow stick.
Pull it up
and
for me.
The stick, it's way back, man. We're talking years. And the stick was coming out of the regions. Like, the ball top was coming out of where you don't want a ball top.
Okay.
And he had to, at certain tournaments, would make him take the cover off because he had to sit down and fondle his waifu to play.
Wait, I don't get it.
Hold on.
I don't get it. It's
do you
an
have
actual...
A, Tam, do you have a picture?
Wait,
no.
It's an actual...
Why bring it up if you don't have a picture?
Wait.
Hold on.
It's an actual body pillow stick.
Yes.
Not like an image of a body pillow on a stick.
No, it
but
is...
But what you're
hold on,
saying...
Hold on.
What? Okay. Brad, what you're saying is that this dude, Quan, made a stick.
I don't know if that's his.
You gotta show that.
I don't know if that's his.
You gotta show that. You gotta show that on the stream.
I don't know if this is his, but he was the trendsetter.
All right. Well, obviously the guy's a genius.
Oh, this might be the one.
He's an engineering wizard.
Okay, this is the actual one. That's the one he made, right?
Well, that is...
Hold up. I don't know how we want to do this. If we can go back to the player cam... Oh, damn, he's got it! He's got it. Okay, so he did make the other one.
All right. So was he playing on that right now,
no.
though?
No. He's playing on a regular stick, right?
Oh, what a sellout. What a sellout. No props.
I'm glad we did that detour.
What a waste of time. Kidding. No. That's an engineering marvel. I like it. I'm into it. I like it.
Yeah, and what I'll say additionally is, you know, it's hard to get Boston on the map. Anyway, we got to do it. Sometimes we got to subsidize stick manufacturing.
Well, look at PAX East is here, sort of putting Boston on the map.
That's the goal.
I mean,
that's the goal. Thank you all for watching. I know we're dual streaming this on the Traveling Controller channel as well as the Cross Counter channel. So if you're new to us, as I said earlier, we are here every week. We do not always play Third Strike, but we play
they
everything.
Knew old man gootecks is coming through. Had to get the old
Jazzy
people
was
engaged.
Coming with or without you, man. It's just we rolled out the carpet because we knew you were here.
Mm.
But
thank
no, you can find us playing Street Fighter. You can find us playing Dragon Ball. But it's playing Tekken, anything. There's over 100
people
here.
What about Uniclear?
Uniclear is here. That's for our, we do, once a month, we do what's called Boston Blue Beat. It's the anime monthly. That's typically where Uniclear is. We do have the anime games at our weeklies, but the biggest turnouts by far are for the monthlies. And anyone that's familiar with the anime scene.
Wait, there's more people here normally? There's hella people here. There's so many people
here. There's over 100 people
for a weekly.
In across all of the tournaments. There's over 100 people here today.
A lot of people here. Where's the crowd cam? That's like there's so many people here.
Yeah, 105 people. Different people entered
wow.
tournaments
today. Not bad. Not bad for a weekly on a Friday night here in Boston. Boston.
No. I'm going to put a stop to that
how you do
right
it?
Now.
How you do it? How
Boston.
Do it? Boston. It's not Boston.
My mother's from Somerville.
Where I don't know where that is. Is that deep Boston? Deep
I mean,
Boston?
Not, it's not deep Boston. It's one of the things. Somebody, Monkey Business, after we streamed with Kizzy the other day, Monkey had a conversation with me, and he was like, yeah, I'm working on my Boston accent. I think it's pretty good. And I was like, nobody that's ever said that sentence has followed it up with a good Boston accent.
The last thing you should have to worry about right now is having enough toilet paper. Please know we're working around the clock to get you more Charmin. Stay safe.
This right here is the new Papadia, which, if I'm not mistaken, is Latin for better than a sandwich. Even has a better pickle. Get a new Papadia for $6. Better ingredients, better pizza, better than a sandwich. Papa John's.
And he proceeded to do his Boston accent.
It was
like 60% there. It was like passable, but anyone from Boston would be able to know.
I actually haven't heard a lot of Boston accents since I've been here. I only kind of heard it on the plane. You know what? I heard it mostly with old people.
So that's the thing is older
the
people.
The Boston accent is dying?
I don't know. It's a globalized world, gootecks. You can experience media from everywhere. The Boston accent doesn't need to be ubiquitous.
Huh. I just feel like here in Boston.
You would think, right?
It would be ubiquitous.
You would think. Well, even, I mean, have you ever listened to John F. Kennedy talk? Which is, I promise it's not the weirdest tangent. But he had a Boston accent.
Yeah.
But the Boston accent in the 60s was different than it is now. It depends on where you go and who you're talking to.
So
that's why
you had to be, like, kind of like American royalty to have that real, real Boston
no,
accent?
That's not quite what I'm saying. I'm just saying different areas of Boston dial it up or down. You go to Somerville, you go to Dorchester.
One more time.
Hold on.
Dorchester.
Dorchester.
Hold on.
I'm gonna show you something.
Dorchester.
How do you pronounce that?
I would say Worcester. Yeah.
You would be wrong, my guy.
Dorchester.
You guys can't see it because it's
Dorchester.
Glaring. That's pronounced Worcester.
One more time.
That's pronounced Worcester.
Worcester.
Let me spell it again.
Worcester.
That's Worcester.
W-O-R-C-E-S-T-E-R. Worcester.
Welcome to Worcester.
Worcester.
You know, but we got Dorchester. We got Glotch. We got, oh, no, I'm going to expose myself. I don't know how to pronounce. I think it's Gloucester, but it's spelled the same way. Yep.
Worcester.
Tim is phonetically writing it down on the screen
Dorchester.
For us right now. They're spelled virtually the same.
How would you spell Dorchester? Like D O R.
It's spelled the same way as Worcester. Oh, it's with the C H instead of the C.
Dorchester.
Yeah, that's Dorchester.
Dorchester.
There you go.
But
Worcester.
Worcester. Yep. Worcester. I'm learning so much.
It's
no,
weird.
I mean, here's the thing. This is the value of traveling to different places.
Oh, yeah.
Because of fighting games, because you get to learn about other, other cultures aside from your own, and you might think.
Don't
that Boston is not that different. Like, if you live in America, you're like, oh, that shit is not that different. if you never traveled before. But
does that mean that I'm supposed to be a cultural ambassador right now? Because if that's true,
yes.
I'm going to do way better than talk about Boston accents and make you pronounce Worcester.
Tell me more about Boston. I like to know. All I know about Boston is New England clam chowder and lobster rolls. That's
lobster
all I know.
Rolls, yeah, clam chowder and lobster rolls.
I've never seen a restaurant on Yelp that had 4 stars and was $2 signs where the meal was $35. I was like, God damn it.
Has anyone taken you to Mike's Pastry?
No, actually. Oh, the Italian spot.
Yep.
Yes, actually, Shidosha was telling me about that. It sounds delicious. It sounds delicious.
Carbs?
I don't have any money.
Mike's Pastry is not that expensive, actually.
Okay, great. Okay, yeah, but yeah, from the people
it's
that
bakery.
From the people that thought that $35 for a lobster roll
meal
was not
expensive.
What
do you want? It's lobster.
It's not $2 signs.
For lobster, it is.
Fair enough. Okay,
no,
fair
Mike's
enough.
Pastry,
okay.
At Mike's Pastry, you don't. The second dollar sign comes from having to wait in line. Because it's a little shack and the line is outside.
Okay. All right. Those are the places I like. Are they open late?
I don't know when they close.
So we got to get there early tomorrow.
Yeah, you got to hit the North End. That's where.
The North End? Dude.
Closes at 11 p.m.
It was like. Oh my God. It's a really expensive Uber ride in like 3 p.m. traffic today. All right, anyways.
Shotokan and Stuffy Muffin.
Oh, yeah, Shotokan played in the cross-counter third strike late night tournament series a couple months ago.
Oh, damn.
Beat everybody's ass. Actually, Shotokan, when I came to the Northeast for the first time, I think I might have stayed with him or we played or something. This was like
yeah, so he's New York, yeah?
No. He was like Rhode Island.
Okay. I'm not extremely familiar with the local.
Why would you be? This was like 2006.
Oh, damn. Okay.
Yeah. Ancient history.
Stuffy Muffin is a local to Boston that I am being told. You got the Yun stuff. Yun is a character that I recognize.
From what? Being terrorized in Street Fighter 4?
That's how it started. We got the Ganage in, though. We low blocking. Okay, we're blocking those. Oh, no, too late.
Yun is the best. So, theoretically, the thing about Yun is that Ganajin, his super, you can build up like 2 times per round.
Right. You see it all the time. Okay, we got the reads though.
That was pretty sick.
This is universally true in any game. If the grappler gets you and just guesses right, you're gonna die.
Yeah.
That's universally true.
That was a good guess. However,
in this game,
Yun, keep an eye on his meter. Because now all it's going to take is one more opening and he gets to activate again.
Yep,
oh, there it is. All right. So.
What's nuts is even on whiff, because you build the meter on whiff in this game, so before the dive kick even hit, he had the bar.
Yeah, so third strike was probably the last Street Fighter game in which you would build meter from whiffing normals.
Right.
I think that they were trying to dissuade people from doing that because there were so many high-level third strike matches, like let's say at Evo back in the day, that would just be like Chun,
like Chun
back
Ken.
Fierce,
yeah,
all day. So they were like, okay, well, this is, you know, we're trying to go full esports. This is boring, so we're gonna change it.
Yeah, it seems like a design philosophy that kind of went away immediately after that generation. Obviously,
oh, yeah.
There in Marvel 2 as well. You know,
oh yeah,
Storm, famous for float full screen.
Yep. I mean, people look back at these games, sorry, old people like myself look back at these games with fond nostalgia, but I can tell you decisively that at the time, there was nobody that liked dealing with that. I mean, I feel like even the players that would do it didn't really like to do it. It's just they had to do it.
Absence makes the heart grow fonder, man. Think of how many people look back on Street Fighter 4 as it was an honest footsies game. Yeah. But they don't sit there. What they don't remember is Akuma unblockable vortexes in grand finals of every goddamn tournament.
I'm going to show you this tweet that got me so mad. Oh, God. I don't even know if I can find it because of the... Oh, here it is. Here, read. I don't... You can decide if you want to, whether or not you want to... Whether or not you want to say who said it, but, oh God, where was it?
In the meanwhile, oh, he's doing a decent job of blocking in the corner.
Read this, you could decide whether or not you want to read it. Because I looked at that shit, and I was like, this is the type of shit where I would retweet that, like, gootecks 10 years, you know, like, old gootecks would retweet that and then say some shit. Modern day gootecks is not going to say any of that because it's not going to do anybody
any good. I remember seeing this on my timeline today, and I hit that final sentence, and I was dying.
Do you want to read it?
I'm just going to... The final sentence of the tweet... I'll read the whole tweet. I won't name names. But... Of all the games that could have united the FGC in 09, why the fuck did it have to be Street Fighter 4? Street Fighter 4 could have been a lot of things, including a better game that ain't stale Wonder Bread. The community result would be the same. Street Fighter 4 be the Pete Buttigieg of fighting games. End tweet. Send.
How much traction did that have, though?
Are you asking about the ratio?
Like 100 and...
It had enough activity that it was on both of our ecosystems. Okay.
How did that make you feel? I was like, imagine, like, hating on a fucking 12-year-old game that united the FGC, talking about the fucking technical aspects of get the fuck out of here.
The thing is, too, is I think Street Fighter 4 brought a lot to it. I think the thing is, now that Street Fighter 4 isn't the game, I feel like people remember it for being something different than it
100%,
was.
100%, that's what I'm saying, yeah.
Like,
but here's the thing, like, okay.
The last thing you should have to worry about right now is having enough toilet paper. Please know we're working around the clock to get you more Charmin. Stay safe.
Buy Crispity Crunchity Peanut Buttery Butterfinger. Get ready for Final Fantasy VII Remake. Get powerful in-game content. Collect them all. Game better with Butterfinger.
Okay, that was pretty cool.
For the record, there was a lot of things that there were a lot of good parts about Street Fighter 4 and a lot of good times that were had from it. But I can tell you, for me personally, when Street Fighter 5 was announced, when I woke up that one day in whatever year that was to the Rise Up trailer, I was like, thank God, if I never have to play Street Fighter 4 again, it'll be too soon.
I think it's not a hot take to say that people were kind of tired with the game.
I was hella tired, and the people who weren't tired were either the guys who were caking off of it or the ones that were new to it, of which I was neither. But I would certainly not make some tweet in 2020 talking about how the game sucks. I'll just say it on stream.
Okay,
but why would I don't know. There was something about that tweet that rubbed me the wrong way.
I see.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Okay, so Ken in Black versus Lucky D. Lucky D, obviously the sort of father of modern New England fighting games. He is Mr. Traveling Controller himself, putting
That's
everything
right.
on, and he's sort of getting schooled a little bit by Ken in Black. Here's Dudley.
Well, here's
I knew
thing.
Lucky D played Ken, which is strange to me because he plays Dalsim in every other Street Fighter game I've seen him play.
Oh, yeah.
So knowing that he plays Ken in this game is something that I've always found a little surprising. Getting stunned, ooh, that's not what you want to see.
Well, these are old man games. Oh, my God, that was fast. I think I might be
Yeah, up. You have another game.
All right, BRB.
I imagine gootecks will be back in a little bit, but thanks to gootecks for hanging out with me, and thanks to you guys for hanging out with us tonight. Once again, we are Balance Patch Traveling Controller. We are here every Friday, and tonight we're bringing you the Jazzy Circuit action. There is the Matcherino. Make sure you check that out with the SALAD3S coupon code to donate 50 cents to the pot. I think we're just waiting for them to send somebody else over here to talk to me. There's the caster cam. I don't know who's going to come and join me. I think it's supposed to be either Furious Roy or Derek, who I believe are both locals. One is our TO for the regular Third Strike stuff, because we do, while we don't always highlight Third Strike, we do have Third Strike here every probably 2 or 3 weeks. We do run a Third Strike bracket here. So we play everything out here. I was saying on Twitter, gootecks asked at one point what the poverty games were here, and we had a bumpin' Sailor Moon community here for a hot minute. Checking how far along the bracket is. I actually haven't had the chance to update it, which has been so razor fast tonight. Yeah, oh wow, no, we're approaching the top eight already, so Everdread and gootecks must be who's sitting down. The winner will play Ken in black. And the Furious Roy and Cosby play for Shotokan, and that is top eight winner's side right there. What's going on? I believe Everdread. Just making sure that we have the overlays and stuff set up properly for you guys. But yeah, thanks for hanging out. And gootecks mentioned it earlier, but we are running Bar Fights Boston tomorrow as part of PAX. So if you're watching on the cross-counter stream, make sure you tune in tomorrow. Celebrating the 20th anniversary of Marvel 2. Justin Wong will be here. K. Brad will be here. Gootecks obviously will be here. Sitting down again with Everdread. And I am being joined. Locust. Oh, shit, too much sanitizer. I burned the shit out of my hand. I knew it was going to happen.
Yeah. Hello, everybody. All right, so who we got?
It is going to be Everdread and gootecks. I was going to say, this has to be a button check. I'm sure gootecks still playing Yurian.
Yeah, this is definitely a button check of some sort.
Well, I think gootecks didn't bring his own stick, so he's actually checking it.
Okay, yeah. How's it been going over here tonight?
I think it's been a lot of reminiscing about Third Strike. Gootecks, obviously, with a ton of history with this game and with the FGC, so he's had plenty to say. Yeah, we saw Everdread a little bit earlier tonight playing the Remy.
The names are mixed up.
Yeah, names and cameras are swapped. So we're going to get that fixed.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think this is a pretty even match. I think this could go either way, personally. I play Everdread a lot online. He's a very strong Remy. He's very good at zoning.
Okay, setting up the mirrors. Doesn't get a whole lot of mileage off of them.
There's the overhead. It should be a grab at least, yeah. Yep, gets the flash kick. That should be a grab flash kick. Get the life lead.
Yeah, he's in a good spot. That's going to kill, yep.
No, he's good. Magic Pixel. There he goes. Round 1, 2, Everdread.
Are you ready? Go. Sitting on another Aegis activation, though, is gootecks. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, because I'm not overly familiar with this game.
Yep.
The mirrors are unblockable if you are able to sideswap?
Yeah.
Is that not in this build?
Nope. That is correct. Yep. If you can throw down a mirror and get on the other side of that mirror, it becomes, it stays the same hit on that side.
Right, that's a thing with projectiles in general in this game.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, like it works, like Oro has the same mechanic. And that's about it, really. I don't think it would work with anything else.
So, fishing for the right situation to be able to get it all set up, I imagine, is what gootecks is doing. Sitting on those two bars.
Yeah, he wants the corner. He went with the EX mirror into a regular mirror, which is a little peculiar to use both your meters like that.
Oh no, not in the corner. Doesn't get the follow-up, but the dash up low forward.
So, game one to Everdread. Pretty strong. But I have faith in gootecks. I think he can make a comeback here. I think he can make the adjustments.
Taking a little bit. I wonder if he's checking the notes or if he's just checking his Twitter DMs.
Both, maybe.
Perhaps. He's got the, he's taken his old notebook from the early 2000s.
Right.
He's converted it to like an Evernote.
Yep.
So hopping back in, Everdread up a game.
parry into the flash kick.
Yeah, he's done a good job. I think he parried just about every knee drop in that last
game.
Yeah,
a knee drop can be a little dangerous in that regard. Nice headbutt. Great low short end flash kick.
Yeah, I think Evernote's playing really, really well right now.
Yeah, he's playing very solid.
His control in the neutral has been really
solid. He's getting that low short flash kick all day.
Ooh, okay.
Finally gets a tackle. Setting up on unblockable, he jumps the wrong way. That's an input error. He's got the corner. Wonderful blocking by Everdred. Nice parry. Gets him off. EX flash.
Oh, doesn't tech that knee drop. But
yeah, but he
punishes.
Gets the throw.
Yeah.
So got the life lead. Gootecks on the megapixel. Gonna parry it all. Yeah. So Everdred on.
Yeah, set point.
Set point, right.
Now, what do you think the adjustment is the Gootecks kind of needs to make here? I mean, it seems as though he's getting the worst of most of their exchanges in neutral.
It does. He's just got to get the corner. It's really Gary's game. Worked is extremely hard against Everdred, because Remy needs the space. So now he's trying to get out of the corner. He switches sides. He's big for Everdred. Now he's got the corner.
And it's probably the first time the Gootecks has really had a life lead in this set.
Yep. But corner can change everything. That's just
that's gonna be a punish. He's gonna get the flash kick. Ooh, nice whiff punish on the headbutt.
Yeah, he's been getting that all day.
Ooh, the instant overhead. He wanted to close it out, but the magic pixel. He gets it with the back throw. Yeah. Gootecks with a round on the board and a mirror stocked.
Interesting start for both. Everybody loving that EX projectile.
Oh, nice jump in, but doesn't follow up off of it. Ooh, nice parry on the knee in the air-to-air situation.
Gets the neutral throw. Everybody just trying to create space. Gets the mix up.
I gotta say, as someone who's principally familiar with Yuri and his Street Fighter V, it's so strange seeing the difference in such a similar toolkit, but the way that it manifests in the engine.
I wish some of the things in Street Fighter V were possible in Third Strike. There's some things in I don't play Street Fighter V personally, but I've seen some pretty interesting stuff from Yuri on Street Fighter V.
Yeah, well, I mean, by shuffling the mirror into the core comeback mechanic in the V-Trigger, it puts so much more potential behind it by guaranteeing that you don't see it as often. I think, obviously without having a lot of familiarity with Third Strike, I think the way that it functions in Third Strike is potentially a little, it's more interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
But I say that because I'm used to watching Berkish come in and, you know, get top three at every tournament with, you know, left-right disgusting Aegis mix-ups in the corner.
Yeah, the mix-ups
and,
are crazy.
You know, watching that for 3 years and you kind of get a little tired of seeing it.
Yeah.
You want to maybe see somebody be able to block Aegis.
All right, so it looks like Everdred took that set.
Yeah, so if I'm not mistaken,
I should send Gootecks to losers.
Yeah, so that puts Everdred in top eight against Kenan Black on winner's side.
If it puts him in round four, that's top eight, which I believe is the case.
Yeah, and I'm refreshing the page. So Furious Roy versus Cosby is the other match to finish out setting up winner's top eight versus Shoto Khan. And then we are obviously still running through the loser's bracket.
Yeah, that'll be primarily off stream. We're trying to run the winners on stream.
And once again, as we've been talking about a couple of times tonight, we do have a Matcherino set up for tonight. You can go and check out the Matcherino and use coupon code SALAD3S to put 50 cents into the prize pot. Great for the players, great for us, and great, obviously, for the Jazzy Circuit and everybody else that continues to show love and support for Third Strike. I think it's really cool that, in general, that we're seeing so much more grassroots support for these older titles of people really propping them up, obviously, with Marvel 2 going on just the same. You know, Marvel 2 at Bar Fights tomorrow.
Marvel 2 did amazing.
Yeah, Marvel 2 in New York now, Battle of the Strongest every year. That game has a new lease on life right now.
It really does. It really, really does. And same can be said for Third Strike. It's Jazzy Circuit has generated a lot of interest.
Yeah.
Real lot of interest.
And Jazzy Circuit, going to be at Final Round.
Yep.
Next month.
Yep, that's going to be an auto qualifier.
Auto qualifier.
I believe so. I believe so. I'm pretty sure.
All right. So how about, since you maybe know a little more than I do, how about you tell them a little bit about how the Jazzy circuit works in general?
Okay. So I think there's, I want to say, 6 auto qualifier events, and the person that wins that tournament gets flown out to the Jazzy circuit finale in Arlington, Texas.
Okay. And I believe that's in June.
Yeah, I think it's early June. And if, let's say if somebody won it twice, then it'd be second place.
Okay.
Who goes? I think it's 6 events, and it might be 8, but I'm pretty sure it's 6.
Okay.
Yeah. So looking at the bracket here, Everdred took that 2-0. Round 4, Shotokan is in the winners for top 8, and
yep.
So it's Kenan Black and Everdred.
Yeah, Shotokan is waiting for Furious Roy and Cosby. Furious Roy, if I'm not mistaken, is another Boston player.
Yes, he is. Yes, he's a training partner of mine. Very strong area and very solid.
Did someone enter the bracket as Barlow's Naughty Accident?
Yeah, and I don't know exactly who that person is.
Oh, that's why you're not giving. That's why he didn't have that name on stream. Oh, God. Some of these names. I would have immediately assumed it was Andre, but Andre doesn't. That's a good point. Oh, no, that's a good point. That's a good point. Yeah, okay, that's a good point. Yeah, so check it out. Oh, God.
Okay, so it looks like Furious Roy lost to Cosby in winners.
Okay, okay.
So that's an update. So that sends Furious Roy to losers.
There's a match in losers that I really hope we get to see on stream.
Which one's that?
Tom Vigil versus gootecks.
Oh, boy.
I really hope we get to see that one. I don't even know if Tom Vigil is any good at third strike.
I haven't watched him yet. I haven't watched him yet, but I personally paid for him to play.
I want to see... That's a match where I just want to see the personalities.
Yeah.
I just want to see the two of them sitting down next to
each
other.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, I'd love to see that. I think we're going to arrange that.
Yeah, Lucky D dropped down to losers. Lucky D has to play the winner of David Bunch and Shinebox.
So top 8 for winner's bracket is set. So that's going to take a backseat for now while we do some losers. So that will give us a chance to get some losers on stream.
Yeah.
And myself, I got to play Stuffy Muffin.
Yeah, I think we saw Stuffy Muffin a little bit on stream earlier, but I...
Yeah, okay, so we could try to get the gootecks match up right now.
Yeah, do you know who's TOing?
Me.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Oh, fine, pick a match, man.
Doing it all. Okay, well, let's do... I'm going to go get them.
Yeah, go for it.
Then I'll come back. Or send somebody back, I might have said.
Gootecks literally has cold cuts on the table over here. I don't even know what to say to that. Yeah, I think we do have somebody. Yeah, okay, we are doing Everdred and Kenan Black. That's what I thought, because that lit up on the challenge. So we only saw Kenan Black once so far today. We saw him versus Lucky D in the winner's side. I think it's the only Dudley that we've seen so far today. Already walking him into the corner. Everdred with plenty of space back. No parries on parries. Okay. Walking out of the corner now is Kenan Black. Oh, that's going to be decent damage stuck in the corner. Blocks the overhead. Doesn't block the follow-up, however. Is that going to chip? Yes, it is. Kenan Black takes the first round.
Okay, so we decided to go into top 8 for winners for the sake of our time.
Forward throw there from Everdred. Walk back into the corner, very similar to the last round, actually. Now with the back throw, almost identical to the last round. Gonna be a big hit confirmed there for Kenan Black. That second fireball, is that literally low?
Depending on the distance, if it's close, you can make it as one parry, but if it's like full screen, you'll have to do a high and a low parry.
Really?
Yep.
Okay, because I've seen it keep clipping in that way, and it's like, is that literally a low fireball?
Yeah, if you're close enough, it can be one parry.
Okay, so Kenan Black going up over Everdred, 1-0. This is winner's side top 8.
Kenan Black, very strong New York player. made the trip out here with Giant Box. Him and Giant Box made the trip out themselves.
Yeah, I think there was a fair bit of activity once it was arranged that this was going to be a Jazzy Circuit event.
Yeah, so people want them points.
Yeah, big shout-outs to all of them that came through.
Shout-outs to Mutant for running the Jazzy Circuit. I know he's out there watching.
Yeah, that too.
Yeah.
Trying to build that meter was Ken and Black.
Okay, so Everdirt got the life lead right now. He's playing some zoning game right now. It's really hard for Dudley to get in, but he doesn't get the super.
He still has another one stocked. I feel like if he's able to get in and get the hit into super, that's going to almost equalize it even.
It could.
Nice parries here from
maybe not at this point.
Yeah, now it's feeling rough.
Yeah, he's just chipping him away. That's a good round. That's a typical Everdirt round right there. Fighters ready.
Engage. Yeah, I feel like all of the Everdirt rounds have kind of looked like that when he's winning. He's really just controlling the neutral.
He's a zoner. Troll zoner. That was very smart.
Yeah, that was a great anti-air.
Very good parry. I would even say that was probably a reaction parry.
Oh, no!
Oh, he could have got the super. That's okay, he takes the round. He's saving his meter, so that was smart.
Yeah, so Ken and Black, set point. Go for it.
Ain't the easiest matchup for Dudley.
Nice patience from Everdread.
Yep. Nice jump by Ken and Black.
Okay.
That was very nice.
Okay, there we go. I was going to point out earlier, it feels like every throw that Everdirt has gotten near the corner has unfortunately been a forward throw, finally getting a back throw to steal the corner, but
yeah,
still smacked by the super.
He wants that neutral throw. Then he can light a flash kick off it. And okay. That's the set for Ken and Black. He's going to move on to round 5.
Yeah, that puts him in the winner's finals.
It sure does.
Yeah, we'll play the winner of Shotokan and Cosby.
So that'll be a best of 5.
In the winner's finals, yeah.
Yep. Okay. Let's take a look at the bracket, see what's going on in losers.
Yeah, see if there's any updates.
Still waiting for that Mixer-Somner match. It's round 1.
If I know Somner, Somner's playing like 7 other games here tonight.
Yeah, we saw him at Street Fighter 5. He's doing the best he can, so, you know.
Plays Tekken as well,
Does
I think.
He? Yeah.
Don't believe he plays Dragon Ball.
Okay.
I'm willing to bet that he...
You didn't know until right now, but you want to order wings from B-Dubs, and you want all 24 sauces and seasonings, and you want free delivery from BuffaloWildWings.com. Buffalo Wild Wings. Roar!
When smartphones are expensive, the family has to share one. Step up with Boost Mobile and get 4 phones for free. Switch to Boost Mobile and get 4 lines for $25 per line with unlimited data and 4 free Samsung Galaxy A20 phones, all on our super fast network.
He entered Grand Blue as well. Everybody's entering Grand Blue lately. Grand Blue's been free to play. I think the goal was we were doing free to play for Grand Blue until the US release.
Yeah, so it looks like we're getting the match that you wanted.
Gootecks, and I will never call him Team 8 Flip Pimp 3000.
Nope.
He is only Tom Vigil. Of course he plays Hugo. I know this is a button check, but I will bet money that Tom Vigil plays Hugo. Always wants to play the Grapply Boys.
Yep.
I feel like I don't even need to know Third Strike to commentate a Tom Vigil match in any game. I just know what I'm in for.
Yeah.
He's going to do some belligerent stuff. Somebody else pointed out the deli meat. Yep, so Vigil indeed locking in the Hugo. Nice parry.
So for anybody following along, this is round 3 of losers.
Now, do you know if Vigil actually plays this game or played this game?
I actually asked him that, and he said yes.
Okay.
When? I don't know. All the times that we play Third Strike here, he's never played with us.
I see.
But
okay.
Apparently knows his way around the game, at least a little bit.
Okay, nice roundhouse getting the ant here.
Yeah, that's a strong move in the corner. Gootecks playing pretty smart right now, giving him the space. This is a really tough matchup for Hugo.
For Hugo?
Yeah, oh yeah.
I mean, I can believe it.
Yeah.
Okay, gets the command grab.
Nice headbutt into Mira. He's going to turn into an unblockable.
Now, is it just me, or is Vigil jumping a bunch so that he can mask his 360s in the jump?
That could be, yeah. I wouldn't know if he knows how to
standing 360.
Standing 360. But I wouldn't put it past him.
He is an old man. He's played these games for a while. The reason I asked about whether he had played this game, which I have received confirmation that yes he has, is that Vigil was around and sort of established in the scene when I started coming out.
Yeah.
Stuck in the corner once again. Okay, gets the anti-air grab this time to Vigil.
It's right over the fireball.
Can you not really follow up off of jump-ins in this game?
Oh, no, you can. In what way do you mean?
I feel like I'm seeing a lot of, like, jump-in over the fireball, the normal hitting, and then not following up on the combo.
It depends on what character you're using. In that instance, you might have been able to get something off that. I really can't say. I don't play either one of these characters.
Okay, it's just that's the second or third time that I've noticed it, so
yeah.
I was curious.
Yeah. I think you're usually safe in that regard. Unless you're playing somebody like Gunner Cat.
The anti-air fireball there.
Look super at you.
Gootecks. Tom's done a lot of jumping, like I mentioned before. Switching to the anti-air fireball, probably smartening up to Vigil here.
Yes, smart move by Gootecks, even if he blocks it. That was a really good move by Tom.
Unfortunately, doesn't pressure very much on the wake up. Nice anti-air from Gootecks.
Walks up, gets a universal overhead into the, I believe that's a roundhouse. Gootecks looking pretty good here.
Yep, but set point for Gootecks, actually.
Yep.
Nice anti-air.
I call that move the fake overhead. It looks like an overhead, but it's not.
The standing roundhouse?
The chop, yeah.
Oh, the chop.
Yep.
But what are those, bud?
I'm not sure.
No, never mind. Oh, wow. SPD's him through the Aegis. We got another one, though. It's fine. Yeah, Gootecks in a commanding position.
Ooh,
here.
Okay.
He combos off the Aegis.
Wow, that was amazing.
Oh, if he gets another good read, if he gets another command grab. Okay, it was the anti-air grab attempt. Clipped out of the air. Trying to jump back up. Gootecks takes it 2-0.
Alright, so I guess we're going to do a commentator switch. Oh, I got to...
Oh, you have to play.
I got to play. Oh, boy. Okay.
Well, I'm sure we'll get somebody else in as well. Thank you for coming and hanging out.
Thanks.
Yeah, so if Locus is going to play on stream, that means the match that we're about to get, as I check the bracket, is Stuffy Muffin and Locust. Bunch coming by to... So, once again, thanks everybody for hanging out. Hope you're all having fun with some Third Strike. I never get to see this game, let alone never get to commentate it. So, thanks once again to Jazzy Circuit for partnering with us tonight. Empty Chair, yes, the best co-commentator. As I... Your boy Empty Chair, I like it. Can somebody take that handle? That needs to be a real thing. Somebody call up the people behind FGC Mom and FGC Dad and do your boy Empty Chair. It is a real Twitter? What do you mean it's a real Twitter? Where have I been? I've been nowhere. I don't know anything about anything, let alone Third Strike. But yeah, so once again, thanks Jazzy Circuit for coming and partnering with us. It's been a blast of a time. I'm getting locked eyes from off screen. I don't know what's about to happen to me. Who's cheese and salami? It's Gootecks's. I don't know. Somebody walked over and just...
I'm in here. You're
in here, okay.
I'm up in here. My name is Ferris Roy.
What's...
We did commentary about...
take the headset. If you're going to do it, take the headset.
We did commentary like 3 years ago.
We did, man. I haven't seen you in a...
Street Fighter 4 launch. No, Street Fighter 5, sorry. 2016. It was at GU.
Yeah.
That's a good
it's crazy that that's something of a throwback now, too.
It's very much so. Good to see you, brother.
Yeah, good to see you. It's been a little bit.
We've got a good Third Strike tournament going on right now. It's been a great night of Third Strike. It's been a great night of Third Strike, brother.
Somebody's blowing him up. Awesome. Like, there's somebody standing immediately off camera, looking him in his eye sockets, telling him he sucks.
I do suck. I just got put in Losers by Cosby. Shout out to Cosby. Great player. Don't sleep on Cosby, man.
Well, so Cosby's in our winner's top eight right now. Cosby versus... Now, I'm exposed myself. Is it... It's Shadokan?
Oh, Shotokan.
Shotokan. Okay, yeah, I've been saying it.
That is the fighting style of the Shotos.
Sure. Oh, yeah, Shotokan. Okay, okay, okay. Okay. That was what I assumed.
Yeah.
But the more I said it, the more it didn't feel right.
Yeah, man. Shotokan. Shotokan 1-2-3. He took the 1-2-3 off his
name. He took
the
1-2-3 off.
Yeah, he was like, I don't know about this 1-2-3. He probably came up with that when he was like...
No, the
13.
Shotokan 1-2-3, that's the Xbox Live gamer tag. He had to bring it to LinkedIn.
Right, he had to get lots professional.
Lots of people putting the professional on there. Hanbam's no longer Hanbam.
He's wearing a suit in his avatar.
Is he?
No.
It's the black and white, the high poly grade. It's like that.
Oh, it's very artistic.
You know the meme of like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Tinder?
Tinder.
It's like the different, like,
no
Shotokan 1-2-3, like the... The different usernames you use.
Shotokan just flexing in a mirror off her Tinder picture.
Doing the Akuma pose.
Oh, God. Probably do some Yun pose. He's a contender to win this.
You think so?
I seeded him first.
You seeded him first. Okay.
That's right.
Well, if he's able to win his match over Ken and Black, Cosby,
I'm
he'll
sure
play Ken and Black
in
winner's
sure,
finals.
Yeah. Yep. I predict grand finals to be Ken and Shotokan.
Okay, well,
we've got a great match against these two players play a lot, all the time. These two are locals to the NEFGC, and they play right here in Boston.
Yeah,
Locust Third Strike.
Locust was just kind enough to sit here and, help prop me up through my Third Strike non-knowledge.
All right.
Helping me to fill in some of the blanks.
Locust just picked up this character, Dudley. He's been messing around trying to find his guy, and he's been doing really well with Dudley.
Is this real fact? Imagine picking up a new character to find your character in Third Strike in 2020.
Well, you know, sometimes it's hard to really find who you vibe with. Some people have to literally pick up the entire cast before they really decide, you know, who they are.
Yeah, well, I'm hoping this isn't representative of how he wants Dudley to feel in his hands, because that first round did not go well for him.
Stuffy is very much a veteran to Hugo. He's been playing Hugo religiously for years now. So this is going to be hard for... This is an uphill battle for Locust right here.
And this is already a very different-looking Hugo than we saw in the last game from Tom Vigil.
He's aggressive. These guys play each other all the time. They know each other's tricks. They're going to go in against each other. They're not going to be afraid to press buttons. As you can see, he's getting those nice buffers. He just lets it fly.
Doesn't block the cross-up. Does Locust and stuff him up and take in the first game.
It's a tough position. If you block that, you could get thrown. You're getting mixed up. That splash has high priority. Let's see if Locust can come back. I think they're going to take their sweet time, take a breather.
Yeah, they got to listen to that wonderful soundtrack.
Oh.
That fantastic Third Strike soundtrack.
It is beautiful. Infinite, you're the best rapper around. By me, but I say that.
Locust having a really hard time playing footsies around these claps. Ooh, getting clapped in the corner now, too.
Yeah.
By claps, I mean command grab.
The clap being a special move just beats out pretty much any poke if it lands. If it whiffs, though, he's in danger. If Dudley can hit it right.
After machine gun blow on hit, I would assume Dudley's plus.
Depends. On
really
your
depends?
Depends on the spacing. It depends on which version you press. There we go. Now we're seeing the stuff. Okay, see? Yeah, no.
Oh no, on block, that's gonna be dead.
Yeah, can't try it twice.
Yeah, work set one, point for stuffing up him.
Works one time, not gonna work the second time. Nice air to air. Good grab. He's got the aggression right now. Keeping the momentum going.
Yeah, this is kind of the first time that it seems like Locust has been able to control the pace a little bit. No, gets clapped out of the dash.
But he took very little damage because it popped him out the air.
Okay, there's the footsies that we need.
That could have been a machine gun blow. He's dropping shit. He's dropping shit.
Oh, yeah, I was going to say that should have been a confirm, right?
Yeah, we got some technical difficulties going on. Maybe some nerves. Okay.
Oh, back throw taking the corner. Nice parry. Oh, that's rough. Okay.
All right. Well,
I was going to say Chip was a fear anyway.
Good game. Good effort by Locust. It's a tough one. Stuffy's strong. Stuffy's dedicated.
Yeah, I mean, well, like I said, the only sort of point of reference I have, at least in particular for Hugo play relative to what we're seeing tonight, was obviously the match with Vigil that was on just before. And night and day, sorry, Vigil, to blow your spot up, but night and day, so much more active.
Yeah.
And, like, the use of clap, the speed and the intensity that
he played
with.
He wasn't afraid to press buttons.
Yeah. Maybe some of it is the matchup. In terms of dealing with Dudley versus dealing with Urien, but
you
I kind of immediately have to believe that he just knows better what he's doing than Vigil. Which, once again, sorry, Vigil.
Yeah, Tom Vigil, I mean, he's facing a big-name player right there. Hugo Urien is not in... Hugo Urien is one of the easiest matchups in the game for Urien.
For Urien? Okay, you think so?
100%. Yeah.
Right, is it just because how
big.
Effectively he can kind of zone
he
and keep
zone
people
him
out?
He can zone him all day, fireballs, hit him when he's crouching. An air fireball can hit him when he's crouching. He's just too big.
Well, damn.
Everything just hits him. You could do weird cross-ups on him in the corner.
See, I'm so used to, like, seeing Hugo's implementation in Street Fighter 4 where, like, a high tiger shot passes through his dome. But they didn't make the games like that before.
It's a disadvantage.
Your hitbox looked a lot like your sprite did.
Yeah, it's a big disadvantage being fat in this game. You're in danger. Hitbox too big.
Back in the day when being tall, being big bodies was a problem, they just got rid of that in Dragon Ball FighterZ.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, no, big bodies, they got rid of fuzzies in Dragon Ball FighterZ. So instant overheads, gone.
Huh. I haven't played that game since it came out.
Yeah, it's the Season 3 dropped on Monday.
Okay.
And it's... dope, but they gave...
What, do they have 80 characters in there right now?
I actually don't know the size
40
of the cast.
40 Gokus?
Right now. There's four.
There's four Gokus?
There's gonna... Yeah, there's four and there's gonna be a fifth.
Oh, great. Let's get more.
But
let's
they...
keep it going.
I will say... No. Is there? No, there's five and there's gonna be a sixth. I'm sorry. I forgot Goku Black is technically a Goku.
Fake Goku.
I will say they all play different.
Yeah.
Even the ones that have very similar toolkits are very different characters.
Well, that's good because it's the same guy.
Yeah.
I hope they play differently.
There is something to be said, but it is kind of wild when you can look and a game has six Gokus and you're like, man, it's kind of crazy that blue Goku is the best Goku now.
Should I pick Goku or Goku?
All right, I'll hop off and grab some water.
Move over. I'll move.
Yeah, Derek is gonna sit back down and commentate a couple of matches for you guys. I'll be back a little bit later on. Thanks everybody for hanging out. Let me give them the run of the show.
It's been, huh?
We gotta get change the names. We got Derek up in here, Tonio.
At Locust 3S.
Damn right.
3S.
This is Boston Third Strike right here, right now.
Yeah, it sure is.
All right.
Just to
today's been a great night. It's been fun. It's been exciting.
Oh,
we got a lot of shout-outs
to give out?
You sure do. First one, I think, should go to Mutant.
Mutant XP for the Jazzy Circuit, putting this thing together. He helped us get ready for this event. He's
truly a mentor.
He's a pillar of the Third Strike community.
Yeah,
so big shout out to Mutant. Sorry you couldn't be here today.
Yeah.
I know they're having a secret tournament at Nika KO's house. I know you guys are doing that, and you ditched us for that. All right?
Stammer,
I'm looking at you. I wore this hat for you today. He's not going to hear this, so whatever.
Oh, he'll see the VOD.
Number one Yurian, though.
That's for sure.
Yeah. All right. Who else? First of all, us.
Yeah.
Furious Roy, Locust, Lucky D.
Lucky D.
We put this shit together for you guys. We got 19 people out here. A lot of them killers. I'm telling you.
Yeah, we were very surprised.
This is a high caliber tournament. People came out.
Yeah.
People traveled.
Yeah.
We got New York over here.
Maine.
We got Maine. We got New Hampshire.
California.
We got California in here. We got Gootecks in the building. Look, he's pretty subpar at Urian, coming from a Urian player. Sorry, guys. I just had to, you know, be real. But, I don't know.
I wouldn't say
probably
subpar.
Further than me.
I'd say, like, just below par.
He's one below par.
Yeah, so this is the Max Arena. You guys can donate for free with a series of retweet links.
Retweet us.
Yeah.
Mention us.
Yeah, just visit the Met Torino.
That's free money.
Yeah, free. You don't have to pay a thing, and it helps us out.
It really does.
You can donate, too, if you want, to the Met Torino.
Also want to give shout-outs to the Third Strike friends, my cursed bro, Vitriolic, Baraboomba. I talked to Gootecks. He has coronavirus. Legit. I don't know what he's doing here. We shouldn't have let him in.
No, we shouldn't.
But yeah, he's got coronavirus. Shout outs to you, Barra. Shout outs to Good Game. Love you. All my people at home watching, Smiley, Chris Mack, Jeff, James, if you're out there. Thanks for tuning in.
I'd like to make a shout out to KD Alpha.
KD Alpha, another pillar. Good guy.
And Big Nasty as well. All the Texas guys.
Very nice.
All the Texas is one of the strongest teams in the country.
Nice people, for sure.
Yeah. And I hope to see them in June, I think, is when the finale is.
Is that the finale?
It's either late May or early June.
I'll try to be there.
Okay, so we're going to run the slideshow real quick. This is what you're seeing right now, is the ad for the finale. As you can see, it's in Arlington, Texas.
We got Yee in there, Stammer. NYC Frankie 3S.
Yeah, you can expect all the best American players to be there.
Oh, yeah.
Just like season one, which we were both at.
That was a fun tournament.
Yeah, that was one of the most fun I've had.
That was a great weekend. Somebody died.
Yeah, we don't have to go there.
Yeah, we walked into the bathroom, and then there was just cops clearing the scene, and we're like, what happened?
Yeah. A lot of people think that it should have been turn.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Tournament should have been ended.
That would have been a sour note 10 tournament.
Should have been. There's no right decision in that circumstance.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace. I know he's from Louisiana. I wish I could remember his name off the top of my head, but I can't.
Yeah, tragic. It was so hot in New York that weekend, this guy had a heat stroke.
That's not true, actually.
What happened?
No, he had a heart condition.
Okay, but he had a pre-existing condition, and the heat aggravated it.
Yeah.
It was crazy that weekend.
It was some of the hottest weather
I took three showers throughout the course of the day. I'm glad we had a hotel room. I just kept going into my room and taking another shower.
We took full advantage of that.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mad showers.
Yeah.
It was shower time.
Very curious to see what it's going to be like down in Texas. I've never been to Texas.
Oh, shit. Is the finale down in Texas?
Yeah, Arlington, Texas, yeah. Yeah.
Okay, well, yeah. We got to plan this out. Hopefully coronavirus doesn't cancel that event.
Apparently it might cancel Cooperation Cup, though.
That's what I hear.
Yeah. I know a lot of locals in Japan are calling it.
It's hard to travel right now.
It is.
I don't know how gootecks got in here with coronavirus.
I don't either.
That's crazy. It's crazy.
I think it's just because he's gootecks. He
I know. Why? You just, this guy's famous, even though he's going to infect everyone?
Yeah.
You
I mean,
let him in?
I'm okay with
that?
It. As long as I get to meet gootecks.
I mean, yeah. I'll get a picture with him later. He's mad drunk, by the way, guys, right now. Yeah, he's really drunk right now. And I'm sober. That's crazy. Usually I'm the one drunk. Here I am, sober, talking to you guys. We're both sober. You usually don't find us like this, so this is in rare form. What else?
What else?
Thank you, Balance Patch, for being such a great venue and having us.
This is great.
Yeah, we made room for Third Strike to be the special event for tonight. We've got all of top eight coming at you guys. We're going to switch off doing commentary. We're going to get all flavors of people in here talking shit, you know?
Yo, yeah.
It's going to be a great night.
For sure. I'd like to give a shout out to my my friends, the Simps, a group of friends of mine from
Simps.
Philadelphia.
Suckers idealizing mediocre pussy.
That's exactly what it stands for. But I'd like to give a shout out to them individually. My friend Riffage, Big Jer, Dark, Grim. If you guys are watching, thank you. You guys are
shout out to Uchi Wallace in the back right now.
No.
Being here,
no
thank
shout
you.
Out to him. He doesn't, no.
Thank you for coming. Thank you for participating.
And Listen to Sleep, because they're a good band.
Salad Days.
Salad Days.
These are the Salad Days.
Because does anybody know where Salad Days is from?
I do.
Well, you do, because I told you.
That's exactly how I know about it.
Right. Yeah, it's an old man saying.
That's Shakespeare, right?
It originated from Shakespeare. I got it from a Minor Threat song, personally.
I like that song. Somebody tweeted at me. They were like, this is the soundtrack to Salad Days. And it was like an album called Salad Days.
Yeah, I don't know who did it.
But those were different guys?
Yeah, someone made an album in Salad Days. I'd like to get who.
I guess that's a common phrase in some circles. I had never heard of it. But anyway, we got a cool logo.
Yeah. I like your hat, by the way.
I wore this for Steel Hammer. It's the Steel Hammer starter kit.
Sure is.
Yeah, I play Urien. He stole my color, but I play Urien. We wear the Ushanka hat. This hat saved my life one time. It gives you +5 defense to your head. And I blocked a bottle to the head one time. So it saved my life.
Is that a true story?
It is 100% true.
I don't believe you.
Why would I lie?
Well, I can think of a few reasons.
Why would I lie about that?
So I guess we're just waiting for more matches to hit the stream.
Yeah, we've been having some delays, a little bit of delays. It's been tough trying to find people for their matches. A lot of people entered in several tournaments today.
We got a pretty sizable Marvel 2 thing going down.
Marvel 2 is crazy. Gootecks was very offended when he heard that I wasn't going to his thing. We've got a match for you guys.
Wow, okay, let's do it. Shinebox and Gootecks.
All right, Shinebox and Gootecks.
Who do you like here?
I'm rooting for Shinebox.
Well, I am definitely rooting for Shinebox. I don't think that goes without saying. But can you take Gootecks?
Are they doing a check?
This is definitely a bunch check. Which
these
is
are,
smart.
These are not each other's characters.
No.
A bunch check is always good. They call it, what do they call it in Smash? Warmies?
Yeah.
Warmies.
Is that what they call it, really?
Something like that. Everything is
something different. They have to separate themselves.
They have that suffix for pretty much everything.
Much love to Smash for me.
Blue Urien. There's like 104 people here, guys. Can you believe that? Alright, let's see. This is, So, Gootecks is known for facing schizophrenic back at home, basically.
Yep.
So obviously he really knows his stuff. Shinebox is keeping up, though. Good chop. Okay.
I don't know much about either one of these characters, so...
Good anti-air. Good blocks. Just getting the momentum going. Good throws. Gootecks is in trouble, but he mashes throw.
Gets the overhead.
Not enough hits to combo.
Nice parry, but doesn't get much off of
good
it.
Good air to air.
Yeah. Oh, die!
My. Could have killed him, but he let him go.
Yeah, he killed him.
Good punish.
Him
oh, Shinebox is not afraid. It is okay to pat yourself on the back for that one. That was a nice round.
Let's see if Gootecks can make a turnaround here. That's not gonna cause anything. Oh, it will.
Knock him out the air, keep the momentum going. Good grab. That headbutt beats, that headbutt beats Urien's headbutt.
That's a good punish right there. Gets him right in the corner. That's a stun.
He's got him.
That's game.
He's got him. Shinebox looking clean. All the way out from New York, represent.
Shinebox is a youngin, I believe.
Oh, he's a young kid. Yeah, he's in college. He plays on that college Wi-Fi. He don't like it that much. But a next level regular and somebody who I've seen improve so much in the past year.
Yeah.
I gotta say, maybe a year ago I didn't really think of him as a threat. I do not wanna face him in the bracket. I'll tell you that. I wouldn't wanna go up against this guy.
I don't have to worry about that anymore. Unfortunately.
I think I'm up against Stuffy.
I had to play Stuffy. Me and Stuffy play online like daily.
Yeah,
so
I commentated your match.
He downloaded me.
Yeah, he was aggressive.
He always does.
He was aggressive. It was good though.
But I'm glad I won a set.
Okay, Gootecks being aggressive, a little bit different.
Gets the cross-up stomp.
Shinebox is feeling himself. Throwing the shit out. That's a fuck up.
It's parry, but doesn't get anything off it.
No, too slow.
Trying to get the red parry.
I sense a little bit of fear coming from Gootecks.
Yeah, I do too.
In the way that he's playing.
Yeah, and a little desperation maybe.
Yeah. See if Shinebox can take advantage of that.
Okay.
Backdash is out of the setup, but that's exactly what he wanted him to do. Good shit, that thing's fast as hell.
Yep.
But Urien's got... Get back in the corner.
Yeah.
Get your ass back in the corner. You ain't tackling out of here.
Almost that stun.
You're gonna get stunned.
It is stunned.
Oh, you're getting stunned. And we're at match point, ladies and gentlemen. And Gootecks is scratching his neck. And he's a little bit afraid.
Yeah.
And we can sense that. Let's see what happens. Oh, is this guy not?
Is he ready for that?
There we go.
That was amazing. He gets a lot.
He's not getting shit out there. Okay.
Okay, that was nice.
All right, what's gonna happen?
Quick rise to the stomp, double stomp, but gets punished for it.
We're going to a game three. Gootecks took that handedly.
That was an interesting little series of events there.
That was a quick one. You guys see, these guys do massive damage. It can be over in an instant.
Yeah, that's Star Trek for you. That's why I love it.
You guess wrong two or three times, you're in trouble. All right, these guys are gonna take their time, I think. I think he wants a timeout. Gootecks wants a timeout. I don't know what's happening. I really don't know what's happening. I think you picked the wrong. Yeah, you picked the wrong. So that's honestly, I mean, if your head is in the game, you're not picking the wrong character. So Gootecks is clearly frazzled.
Yeah.
Big whip. Wakes up with throw. They've really got a feel for each other right now. And somehow that crazy knee drop lands, and he gets the mix-up as well.
Life deeper. Wow!
Really
that move is such a good...
Those axe kicks can really get you.
do a red.
It's tough, man. We got the sweet spot. Alright.
Alright, now
come
Gootek.
On, shine box. Come on, let's see it.
Gootek
get something
point,
going.
Goes right. He starts with the tackle.
Okay, couldn't get the second parry.
Gets that. Goes for the far headbutt. Gets hit for it.
Oh, God. He
gets
him out
the tackle.
There.
I'm not going to get anything off except for
it's
a throw.
Hard, it's very hard to juggle Alex, but that's the whoopee land of that. Alright, we're drops
yeah,
it.
He's pretty good with more on depth, but then he stopped the chop,
yeah. Stuffed it. Okay, though, it's in the corner.
Now, Scheinbach has been a little frazzled.
Oh, boy.
Is it the mirror? Yeah, it's just,
that's it.
That's unblockable combo number
close.
One.
It was very close.
So, Gootex makes a turnaround.
Alright, is this... This is losers?
That was losers, yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
It was indeed losers.
I really hope I don't have to face Gootecks later because I was just talking shit about Gootecks and now I might eat humble pie, but it is what it is.
What did Dan want?
I don't know. Hopefully these guys could get the tournament rolling. I know.
When are you coming up? Who are you playing?
Stuffy.
You're playing Stuffy.
And I, yeah.
That's a grudge match.
Yeah, for Stuffy it is.
Yeah.
It's not for me. shoot you. What else, guys?
Roy, I need you for tournament.
All right, guys. Looks like I'm up. Wish me luck. I'll need it.
I'll be pulling for you.
Pretty bad at this game, so.
But I got to remain neutral in my commentary. But at the end, I'm rooting for you, all right, bud?
See you guys. I'll be back.
Who wants to get in the commentary group?
You guys want both hop in?
Oh, you gonna hop on too? Yeah, whatever. All right, we can do that if you want.
Woo! Oh my. That was... Oh, this is weird. I never take the headset off until the stream is over, so putting a headset on that's warm because someone else is wearing it is really bizarre.
Oh, it was kind of gross.
It's really bizarre. Normally I warm it up and I don't notice all night.
Oh, well, hey, you know what, Brad? We warming it up tonight.
I guess we
spreading
are.
Spreading the coronas here and there.
I said to you earlier, I'm like, man, I border on hypochondriac. I'm hella worried about that. So I guess we're just joking about that all night.
Well,
that's me being a loser, though. I'll own it. Right to the chin.
You know, being a hypochondriac can have unseen benefits because, actually, I met one of my best friends of my entire life through being a hypochondriac.
Okay. How does that manifest?
So I was in high school.
Okay.
And I was there by my locker. And there was a guy in my Spanish class who liked to pick on me.
Okay.
And so I'm there by my locker. And he walks by and he fucking slams the locker door on my finger.
Ooh.
Yeah. This was in high school. And I'm like, oh my God. And I'm like, bro, like,
shit's broken.
I'm a hemophiliac, like, because I started bleeding.
Wait, no, you were capping him, though.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I mean,
so I'm like, oh my God, like, I'm going to die. And I start freaking out, and so he starts freaking out, obviously, because, you know, you slam the door of a locker onto some fucking nerd's finger and you don't actually think they're gonna die.
Right.
It's not really attempted murder. It's just, you know, messing with you. And I'm like, oh God. And so he starts freaking out and I'm like, and we've been best friends ever since.
Oh, yeah.
That's how it's done.
I'll make sure to alert high school me as to how to have done that.
Well, okay, you know, there's a lot of people out there sometimes that may get picked on sometimes, so I'm just trying to let them know that You know, sometimes you got to turn around on people.
Yeah, it's important. So this is our winner's side top eight. The winner of this plays Ken and Black in winner's finals.
Ken and Black.
Who's he play?
He's
playing. The Dudley guy?
Yes.
Oh, that guy's good.
Yeah, so Furious Roy was sitting with me a little while ago. He was saying his belief was that grand finals is going to be Shotokan and Ken
Shotokan's really good. Yeah, Shotokan's really good. Ken and Black's really good. I can tell, as an old person, that these guys know how to play.
Eventually, you just get a sense for it, right? Like, you can just read it.
Well, here's the thing. What's your main game? What's your favorite game?
Right now or in general?
Right now.
Right
or,
now?
Or your favoriteest game?
I'm a Marvel guy at my core.
Marvel 2?
Marvel 3. Marvel 2 is before my time. You're exactly old enough to make fun of me for that.
So
Marvel 2 was just before my time.
So eventually there will come a time where you could just look at somebody playing Marvel 3 and be like,
oh,
nah,
I'm there now.
You don't
know,
how to play.
When someone's whack.
Well, yeah. And you know when somebody actually has been playing the entire time. Marvel 3 has been out. You know? Because there's not really... Well, maybe there is. I don't know. I don't actually know if there's a whole lot of new tech developed in Marvel 3. I don't know. But in this game, it's been... Okay, let's say that Third Strike died in 2009 when Street Fighter 4 came out.
Okay.
So, it's been about 11 years, and I haven't seen a whole lot of new shit in this game. But in Marvel, maybe it would be different.
Maybe I couldn't speak to that, but...
Marvel 3?
Yeah, I couldn't speak to it. I know that...
Because you stopped paying attention.
I mean, yeah. I'll own that. But I will say, and I talked about this a little bit earlier today, I think it's sick that so many of these older titles are getting this new lease on life now with all the grassroots stuff that's going on, like Jazzy Circuit, Battle of the Strongest for Marvel
2. And why do you think that is?
Because people are still playing it.
Who?
The old heads.
Yes. This is the argument that I've been having recently.
Ooh, okay,
with people, which is, oh, okay, all right, we're going to, oh, no, drops it. Out of there. I personally think that the money in esports is in retro. Why? Because, how old are you now?
28.
All right, so between the ages of about 8, well, I mean, really up until you're about out of college. Let's say somewhere between 22 and 24. Did you have more money then when you were, let's say, a young Brad Muse of, you know, 20, or in your early 20s? Did you have more money then or now?
I mean, now.
Do you think you're going to have more money
now? Talk to me in a year, it'll be different.
That's what I'm saying. Exactly. There is no money in esports.
Well,
there is no money in esports. You know why? Because young people don't have any money. So there's this gap. It's like the money in esports is on the low end and the high end. So if you're like, I don't know, 13, 14 or younger, your parents that are older might pay
for you.
In the same way that, like, for me and my generation, like my parents, I'm really lucky, right?
Mm-hmm.
My parents pay, you know, I was in baseball, basketball, piano lessons.
Mm-hmm.
That's the way that old, like, my generation's parents would spend money on investing in their kids, right?
Okay.
Now, if your kid is like, you know...
Every click,
every frame,
every press,
every sound.
They're playing aggressive.
I'll take mid, every advantage.
When the difference
between winning and losing
is measured in milliseconds.
Everything
counts.
The Alienware Legendary Battle Station.
You might invest in an e-sport.
Smash, Street Fighter,
sure.
Fortnite, whatever. Because you want your kid to be the best, right? So what other 9-year-olds have a Smash Brothers coach.
Like, wait, none. Is that a real thing?
Bro, Broly Legs trains people. Broly Legs has trained my friend Aaron, trained his son for months and months and months in Smash. The kid is like 9 years old.
I didn't even know Broly Legs played Smash.
There you go. So, the money in esports is with the kids, actual children, and with older people like myself. Because older people don't give a shit. I mean, I'm the exception, right? Like, I mean, I barely even care. But
I'm sitting here like, you're sitting here giving a goddamn the Communist Manifesto of esports dollars.
What do you mean the Communist Manifesto? It's just reality. Look it. Old people like ourselves. Okay, let me ask you this. As a 28-year-old, how many women do you know that are that will take gaming seriously as some sort of career path? Women that are your age.
I mean, not many.
What about older? Women that are older. Do you have an older sister or cousin?
I don't know, but I imagine it's less
pretty
if you
slim.
Grow up in age.
Pretty slim. Yeah. Yeah. And so think about yourself or dudes that are like in your demographic that, let's say, they don't play competitively, they're not in gaming, they're just normal ass dudes, like guys that you grew up with, right? They got jobs.
Yep.
Right? They're like productive members of society. They don't know about Street Fighter V. Did they play Street Fighter II when they were growing up?
Probably.
Probably. So what will get those people interested in gaming? It's not the new shit. Old people don't give a fuck about Fortnite. They don't care about Tekken 7.
That's
they don't
fair.
Care about Street Fighter 5. Why would they?
That's
why?
Fair, man.
How? Why would they? You'll see it.
Never played Fortnite. I'm too old for that.
Exactly.
Ken Black is up this first game here over Shotokan.
That's right. Old man games. Old. I mean, he don't look that old, but he looks kind of old. He looks old enough.
You think he looks old enough?
He looks old enough.
Is that sort of like the, you sit down, you know, if they've been playing, like you can just look and you're like, you're not old enough to be good at this game.
100%. 100%. Dude, old people don't care about new games. Get out of here. But if you put an N64 controller and Mario Kart 64 in front of anybody aged, I don't know, like 18 to like 45, they'll be like, yeah, I know how to play Mario Kart. Retro is the great uniter.
Not a bad take.
But it's a hot one.
I'd call it like lukewarm.
All right, well.
Back with the second game. This is Winners Finals Best of 5. We have not talked about this game at all.
I've been talking about the game the whole time.
You've been talking about...
I'm talking about the meta game.
You're taking it one step beyond the meta.
Yes. That's right.
The only matchups you're interested in are age demographics matched up to spending habits.
Look it. Once you... That was like
that was like the
Obama. You ever seen that Barack Obama animated GIF
where he
kicks the door? That's what that guy did. You guys will never see it on stream. Anyways.
Well, I mean, apparently the only time a BP employee wants to get on stream is to dab behind me.
Oh, what was her name? Spuds?
That was her handle. Yeah.
Ooh, Shotokan gets that one extra hit right there. Working on a perfect. Ooh, bit tries to bait out the EXSPD, EXDP. Nope.
Yeah,
nope.
No, nice.
You can't do that.
Finally answering back, Shotokan.
I really hope Shotokan wins. Because I'm well equipped for the deadly match.
Oh, I see. You want him down. And you think you're going to make it to Losers Finals? If you really think it, spit that shit.
Well, I got to go through Everdread, I think.
Let me check the bracket.
Oh, I gotta play an Akuma?
Did you played Shinebox already?
Yeah.
I'm refreshing the bracket. I haven't refreshed it in a minute. Yeah, you have to play Cosby. Oh, wow. Yeah, no, Shotokan with the parry on the way on his wake up. Okay, clapping back.
All right, 2-1, Ken in black, Shotokan not going down without a fight. These guys are playing first to three to get into grand finals.
Furious Roy did call this as his grand finals pick.
That's right. We are here at Balance Patch in Boston, Massachusetts. If you guys are watching at home, you guys are enjoying that third strike. We urge you to go to matchreno.com and find the link where you can use coupon code SALAD.
Salad3S.
Salad3S.
And I know a couple of people have already shown some love because I've seen that thing.
Do it.
Climb in a little bit.
Salad3S. Go to matchreno.com if you would like to contribute to the pot without actually busting out your wallet. I mean, obviously, you could donate if you wanted to. But we ain't asking you for money. We just asking you for your social media reach. Because what good is money anyways when the coronavirus takes us all out?
The cross-up dive kick to take out Ken in black, too. Shotokan three rounds straight.
Download complete. Ooh! Baits the jump in right there. Oh, my gosh. Uh-oh. Here comes the super. All right, 50-50. High-low. Oh, baits it out. Oh, no.
Does it punish?
Was a half a second too late. Oh, my gosh.
That's so much damage.
Standing roundhouse into the command dash, into the super. Does so much damage. So hard to do.
Hey.
All right, here comes Ganade Jin. All right. Goes for the reset, backs off a little bit. Oh my gosh, caught him sleeping.
It is actual download complete. I feel like Shotokan is guessing right in every situation. All the parries, even that dive kick catching him.
Well, he's got the experience, I'll tell you that much. This man has been playing this game for a long time.
Oh yeah, you said earlier that you had played with him back in the day.
Oh yeah. When I went to like TGA in like 2006 or 7 or something, yeah. It was a long time, man. Honestly, I love this game, but I really don't think I could have played. I don't think I could have played this game for like 10 years, like after I stopped. I don't know. It's not that I needed a break. It's just that, like, how do you play the same people over and over and over again for 10 years?
I mean, lots of people do, but that's why games kind of wither.
Many? Lots? Or some? Because I feel like most people would just play the new shit. Obviously, there are some people. Ooh, he couldn't punish. Oh, that was so ambiguous. He was at the distance where it was hard to tell if he was going to be able to punish. Oh, no uppercut right there.
Okay, walks under on the neutral jump.
Yeah. All right, so now Ken in black's got to take it easy. He's got a good life lead here. Obviously, you can't take it too easy against Yoon because he gets Ganagen just like that.
Yeah, it is set point for Ken in black. I didn't realize that. Nice.
Oh, no. He didn't throw him into the corner. That could have been it. Oh, well, it is it. Oh, and we got the reaction shot. Nicely done. That was pretty good. That was pretty good. Yeah, very impressive.
Shotokan kind of turned it on there.
He got a lot of rounds.
It really seemed up until that sort of last even sequence, it really seemed like he had the, like you said, download complete. Like, yeah. What the hell else do you say? It was clean.
So close.
Four rounds.
Mm. Mm. Well, so Ken in black is going to advance to grand finals.
Yep.
And Shotokan is going to go down to losers finals, where he is going to wait for a little while.
Yeah, we do have losers top eight. We are at losers top eight. You played Shinebox. That was the first match of losers top eight. So you're going to have to play Cosby.
Who's he play?
I think it was.
It doesn't matter who he plays.
I walked into it. You remember earlier I said I'd tee you up? I teed you up.
You're welcome.
I did it. No, you're welcome. Don't you dare take credit for that. And then Furious Roy and Stuffy Muffin round out the other half of Losers Top 8. The winner plays Everdread. What's good? All right, so Derek is asking to hop back on, so I'm going to take another break and grab some more water.
All right.
I will be back in a little bit. I'm sure they're going to call you for a match in a minute.
All right.
See you guys in another little while.
All right. Quick swap out. That's right. All right, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us here at Balance Patch, coming to you live from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is gootecks. If you are watching on the Cross Counter channel, make sure to head over to the Traveling Controller channel, Twitch channel. What's going on, man?
Hey, gootecks.
How you doing?
Pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
So what
did you play?
I played. I'm out.
What happened?
I blew it, basically. I'm not very good against Hugos.
Wait. Did you play the guy that I played?
The Stuffy Muffin?
The only Hugo guy in here?
No, you played the other Hugo.
Oh, okay. All right.
No. No, I played Stuffy Muffin, who is Derek Daddy. That is not my name. Kill whoever did that. No,
bro, if enough people don't call you Derek Daddy, you're not doing something right.
I'll take it. I mean,
that's right, ladies. Derek Daddy.
Derek Daddy. I'm your daddy.
Daddy Derek.
So this next match we got coming up is Furious Roy against Stuffy Muffin. Stuffy Muffin is the one who exited me. Both of them are local players. They're on right now. Stuffy Muffin. You got the names mixed up.
Stuffy Muffin playing Hugo. Furious Roy playing Green Urian. Ooh, what a sweep right there. Oh, yes. I'm not even quite sure what his taunt does. But it is kind of useful for whatever reason because it hits low.
Yeah. How do you feel about this matchup from the Urian perspective?
Honestly, this is one of my favorite matchups.
Is it? Yeah.
Because I feel like Hugo's relatively easy. I mean, it's not looking easy right now, but I feel like Hugo's relatively easy for Urian to kind of to pick on. Hugo has to have... Hugo's got to get so many reads right.
Yeah, it does do damage boost. That's right. Yeah.
Oh, damage boost. Oh, is that Mutant XP in the chat room? Oh my gosh. So for those that do not know, I don't know why you would know, but fun fact.
Yeah.
Mutant XP, creator of the Jazzy Circuit.
Of course.
Was one of wee little Nooblet Gootex's mentors in Third Strike.
Yeah, he's one of my men. I played him a lot online. He's taught me a lot about Third Strike. So
yeah, same.
We got that in common.
Except I had the misfortune of having to play him in person.
You play as Necro?
Yes.
Yeah, Necro and Urian.
Yes.
It'd be a tough matchup for Urian.
Oh, yeah. No, I am well-versed in the Necro matchup. Probably Necro and Dudley. I am trained the most in because of my Third Strike Sensei's XP and Victoli.
Now, I do remember reading somewhere or seeing somewhere that your favorite Third Strike matchup is Urian versus Urian.
I actually find the Urian versus Urian mirror match to be my favorite matchup in all of Street Fighter.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
Can you give me a reason why?
I don't know. I mean, I got a lot of mental damage, like scar tissue from that particular matchup, but
yeah.
There's something about it that just, it's good because you really get a test, right? Because at the end of the day, is Urian a good character because he's a good character or because of unblockables?
Right.
Personally, I think it's because of unblockables.
So if you
fight another Urian who is well-versed in unblockables, then you got yourself a real match.
Yeah. As they would say in Marvel.
Yep. But yeah, shout-outs to Mutant XP for holding it down in Third Strike, creating the Jazzy Circuit. Giving old men everywhere a reason to live.
Right. It's so true. Stuffy is the most humble dude. He absolutely is. And right now, he's got a 1-0 lead right now against Furious Roy. Furious Roy is kind of our knight here. We think probably the best player around here.
Really?
Yeah, I would.
Best player around here? Out here is a Urian player?
Besides Shotokan. If we're counting Massachusetts, yeah, I'm going to say Furious Roy is the best Massachusetts player right now.
Not bad.
Stuffy Muffin hails from New Hampshire.
How far is that from here? That sounds far as fuck.
It depends where. If you're like near the border of New Hampshire, it don't take long to get to Boston, maybe 45 minutes.
Oh, okay.
But if you're like way
out here, you know what it is? I feel like when our founding fathers were founding this country, they were like, here's a state, and here's a state,
right,
and here's a state, and yeah, you get a state,
yeah,
and you get a state.
Right.
And then once time went on, it was like, nah, you don't get a state. Nah, you could be a city, maybe
right,
even a county.
Right.
But the states get bigger as you get further west.
That's right. Imagine if the Louisiana Purchase remained a state.
What a deal. Like, what, I mean, it was already a deal, right? But
what a deal.
That was a deal. That was the deal of a lifetime.
Yeah.
Multiple lifetimes. Louisiana Purchase? What do they get? What do they get? Ah, yeah. You want a sticker?
Yes, I do want a sticker.
We got cross-counter stickers here. We're distributing the propaganda.
I support.
Thank you.
So that was a nice little move by Furious Roy, but he paid for it with the fireball.
Oh!
That was dirty. He's trying to set up the unblockable. He's going for it.
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
Stuffy Muffin makes an initial block, disrupts the unblockable with the overhead.
Oh, my gosh. That was, I mean, honestly, he risked it all, right?
Yeah.
Because one forward parry, he would have been dead, and Furious Roy would have tied it up.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh no. Doesn't go for the tackle right there and goes for the reset instead of the unblockable. Okay, here we go. Oh no. Why did he do that? Why did he do that, Aegis?
Yeah.
No. Furious Roy. Come on. Okay. There we go. Yes. Okay. See, I actually prefer to do the Fierce Aegis Reflector because it pushes them further back.
Yeah.
Or it doesn't push them further back, but you have the opportunity. Dash forward, you go for the throw, then for the reset. Most people, if they're under a certain age demographic, they don't actually know what to do in that situation. Only old men know what to do. Right. You got to have your boomer card to know what to do in that situation.
Does Steelhammer agree with that assessment? I would love to know. Because I know there's the sweet spot they try to get them just so they can't move. I'm not much of a Yurian player. So I can't really say, but I've heard.
Why do you play this game?
Why do I play this game?
Yeah, how old are you?
I'm 32.
Okay, all right, you're old enough.
But
all right, you just look young. Okay.
Yeah, but I did only start playing this game about 3 years ago.
What?
Yeah. Well,
why would you start playing this game in 2017?
That's a great question.
There's so many different.
I played
fighting
Street
games.
Fighter 4.
Okay.
I was very into Street Fighter 4. And when Street Fighter 5 came out, I was a little disillusioned.
Okay. Oh, that was nice. That was sneaky. So you were like, you know what?
I went into the dirty world to fight Kid.
Here's the thing. You liked 4, and you didn't like 5, so you went back to Third Strike?
Yeah.
Bro, Street Fighter V is the Third Strike of this generation. You know that, right?
Oh, I don't know.
There is so much about 5 that is taken directly from Third Strike.
It's true. I don't deny that. But I have no rebuttal. I can feel the way
you're
I
just
feel.
You're just a man of taste and culture.
I just feel like it's like when I revisited Third Strike, I just felt like it was such a perfect game. It's like, why do you need, you know, there's no chess 2, you know? Like, just stick
there's
with
There's no what?
There's no chess 2.
Chess 2?
They didn't invent chess 2.
Okay, actually.
Well, where are we going with
David Serlin actually tried to invent chess 2. I'm almost positive. You guys can fact check me on that one. I'm almost positive David Serlin tried to make chess 2.
Is it like
Please
one of those, like,
look that
three-dimensional
chess? I don't know. I'm just saying.
You didn't know until right now, but you want to order wings from B-Dubs, and you want all 24 sauces and seasonings, and you want free delivery from BuffaloWildWings.com. Buffalo Wild Wings. Roar!
The last thing you should have to worry about right now is having enough toilet paper. Please know we're working around the clock to get you more Charmin. Stay safe.
Yes, is the 3S of this generation. That's how I feel.
He absolutely did. You see? They did try to make a chest too. I've never played it. I don't know. I'm just saying.
I'm intrigued.
Old man games.
But
chess is the oldest old man game.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That goes back.
Chess 2, the sequel. Thank you, David. Obi. It's kind of wiggy and everything. You can choose different characters in chess. You see?
Yeah.
I'm not saying it took off. I've never played it. I don't know anything about it. I just know it exists.
Yeah. Well, why did Street Fighter V take off?
Okay, first off, Street Fighter V didn't take off.
You're very true. That's a good point. That's a true point.
Oh, here we go. Ever Dread versus Furious Roy. Yes.
Loser
this
bracket,
is,
yeah.
Yes, here we go.
This is a match you're waiting for.
I lost to Ever Dread. I've been looking at Ever Dread's posts on SRK. Well, I guess I haven't been looking at it for 20 years, but I remember seeing his, you know, posts back in the day on SRK. SRK, for the uninitiated, is the parent company of Evo. You have to say that now.
Really?
I mean, you can't assume that anybody knows anything. Look, first off, you didn't know there was a chess too, okay?
I didn't. I feel like SRK is a little bit more common knowledge than that. At least I would like to hope so.
Oh.
Remember when they almost got rid of it? I was sad.
Got rid of what?
SRK forums.
Oh, the forums?
Yeah.
Bro, you know what they're getting rid of now? SRK rankings. That I don't know about. But they are they're getting rid of the SRK ranking system.
Oh, I have no problem with that. Oh, the ranking system, the ranks of players?
Yeah.
They're talking about the tier list.
No. The actual ranking system that keeps track of wins and losses. Oh, okay. Furious Roy, I think he's not old enough to know the real setup. All right, that was pretty good, though. He's old enough to option select down parry, though.
Roy's been around for a while. He's about my age, but he's been playing for 10 years, give or take.
It's nothing.
It's nothing. For sure. I know. I forgot.
I'm kidding. I'm just being an asshole. It's just... Don't let your dreams be dreams. It's not. Oh yes,
yeah.
Justice. That was sick.
Wow, look at that trade. Throw attack.
Oh no. Okay. All right. Yeah. I think Everdred's.
Everdred's
I think
Everdred
is.
Man, yeah.
Everdred is taking this one.
I don't know. I wouldn't count Roy out yet. He's just gotta play super clean, and that wasn't it. So that, I do believe this is a best 2 out of 3, first to 2. I don't think we're in losers finals yet.
Nah.
Yep, thank you.
All right, well, Everdred, from the depths of the SRK forums in a pre-Street Fighter 4 era.
I gotta give a shout out to Everdred. He came down here from Maine by himself.
How far is that, though?
It's a distance. It's quite a distance.
I thought you said it was 45 minutes.
No, that's New Hampshire, bro.
Oh!
Yeah, we're talking about Maine. He came from almost Canada.
He came to get this. He came to get these points.
He came from America's Canada.
I gotta remember that one. Maine, America's Canada. Shout out to all the maniacs.
The maniacs. That one. You know, from New England, you think I would have heard that one by now.
Oh,
I'm sure you heard the Massachusetts one.
What's the Massachusetts one?
The Masshole.
The Masshole. I see. I'm from the West Coast. I've heard that one.
Of course.
But ain't nobody heard about the Maniacs. Nope, that doesn't work.
I think
it doesn't work. You can't do that. You have to do the dash tackle.
Character specific?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, again, in that, see, as a young man, you know, you gotta listen when the elders tell you about the character specific stuff.
Yeah.
So, when Urien gets that down pierce, like, he can't do the normal unblockable against Remy, Dudley, Necro, and 12.
Yeah, yeah.
You have to do the dash tackle.
Jeez,
and against the twins, you have to do the back dash, down pierce, knee drop.
Every door
takes most
it.
People don't know that.
So that
I don't know why anybody would know that.
That's the end of Furious Roy, unfortunately. I expected him to go further.
I'm telling you, bro, you don't know the fucking old man character specific stuff. You are not beating an old person.
It still says Derek Daddy. I don't like
bro,
that.
Bro, you are Daddy Derek.
All right. I mean, you can't.
Girls don't call you Daddy?
Girls don't call me.
Join the club, bro. It's okay.
Right?
We got each other.
Yeah.
We got each other.
I'm cool with that.
Girls don't call you Daddy. Girls don't call me.
We're just having a good time over here.
I know. All right. Wish me luck. All right, Brad. All right, I'm taking it, Brad.
I hope girls call you Brad.
Can I be mad disrespectful?
Absolutely. The more disrespectful, the better.
How, when he laughing, his face looked like he's got the paralysis thing that Jeff Bridges uses in Iron Man 1.
Oh, my God. I didn't see it, but...
I'm not normally that disrespectful, but I know he would take the joke. I'll tell it to his face later, so I'm not a scumbag.
Oh, he'll see the VOD. So, where are we at in the bracket here?
We are
going to do the remaining matches on stream.
Yeah, and we are, I think we're at a point of fifth place and up. I think that's where we're at in loser's side.
Okay.
Because obviously winners is already situated. So, I think it's Gootecks Cosby. If I recall correctly, you have the bracket over there,
yeah.
So I don't need
loading
to pull it up.
Quite slowly.
Are you on the BP internet?
I am on the BP
oh,
internet.
Oh, shit. I was going to say that's what you need to be, but now I'm exposed. Yeah, so that was that Furious Roy and Stuffy Muffin?
Yes, it was.
Okay.
Yep.
And who won? I didn't...
No, wait. That was Everdread and Furious Roy. And
oh,
losers.
Okay. Oh, good. Okay, then my bracket isn't updated.
Yeah.
So that means that the winner of Cosby and Gootecks goes on to play the winner of that match in the fourth place match. So we're just shy of top four.
Oh, boy. So have you played Searchwake at all?
Not competitively. I've noodled with it in the way that, like, everybody did,
okay.
You know, before they got into the scene. And when Street Fighter 4 launched, we had a MAME cabinet at a buddy's house. So we played all kinds of vintage arcade games.
Yeah.
But, you know, we were all whack. So, you know, we played vintage arcade games in the way that, like, everyone played Street Fighter 2 at the laundromat.
Yeah.
Before that was a real thing.
So you get started.
Could you imagine if Gootecks comes all the way here for bar fights and then manages to, like, win a Jazzy circuit tournament?
That would, honestly, I like Gootecks, but that would be a shame. It would be a shame for everybody in here. We should all be embarrassed if that happens.
Well, I mean, Ken and Black and Shotokan both look like they're playing really well.
They do.
And Furious Roy said that was his call for grand finals.
Yeah, yeah. Was mine too.
Okay.
They were both seeded 1 and 2. Gootecks has been good and he's been bad. More good than bad.
Yeah, I feel like the only match of his that I've seen that looked a little sus was the one against Vigil, and I think everything about that one looks sus, and I feel like Vigil can sometimes just bring that out of people, where the way he plays sort of enforces an energy into the match where shit can be a little weird.
Yeah. Sure.
You know, what else are you going to do against a Hugo jumping around constantly?
So it sounds like we're getting started here.
Yeah, I think there was, we had to wait a little bit, I think, because Dan had told me that Cosby was
in another game. I don't know if this is actually starting, but our stream producer is not here. Okay, he's running back up so we can switch the gameplay feed for you guys. Yep, this is Loser's Bracket. This is a fifth place match, Cosby versus gootecks.
Yep.
Cosby bringing the yang, it seems. Getting the Aegis set up. Hit low, doesn't get the combo. In a good spot here, though, is gootecks to take this first round.
I love Cosby's yang.
When smartphones are expensive, the family has to share one. Step up with Boost Mobile and get four phones for free. Switch to Boost Mobile and get four lines for $25 per line with unlimited data and four free Samsung Galaxy A20 phones, all on our super fast network.
Gordon Hayward shows his opponents no mercy. No, seriously, he's like ridiculously competitive. Which is why he refuses to play on anything but gamer-grade internet from Xfinity.
As hell, though, yeah. And I like that. Yeah. I like that he went for that. That's.
I don't know if that was throw invincibility. I doubt it. But
I think he. It. My guess is he was just a little too far out of range.
That's what I would go with. That's the sweet spot, Aegis. Gets the overhead.
Now, what is sweet spot, Aegis?
So sweet spot, Aegis is when you just barely put it at them so they can't move. It's not on them. It's right in front of them.
Ah, okay.
I'm not a Urian player, that's just my understanding of it. Maybe Steelhammer can give a better explanation.
Okay.
Nice headbutt. Doesn't get much off it, though.
What are the odds that was an attempt at, like, a cross-up knee so you could get the unblockable mirror, and, like, you just didn't get it? I know the charge partitioning can be a little tight to be able to do
Urian's got a lot of character-specific stuff. I'm not sure that you can do that against a twin. There's only a few characters where you can knee drop over them to get the unblockable.
Okay.
And I don't think the twins is one of them.
Okay, so then the neutral jump button was probably a read then.
Something like that.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not in his head, I can't say. Sanibu. Constant pressure. Nice blocking by gootecks. Nice parry.
Was that a combo drop on the command grab, or does Yang not get the combo on the flip?
Yeah, I think it was a combo drop. He should have at least got something off of it.
Ooh, we swing through those.
Gets the EX, Rekkas. He's going. He's hitting that fierce. Got the corner. Loses the corner, but gets the fierce two hit.
Yeah, gootecks in a rough spot here. He doesn't have the bar for an Aegis or anything to try to make anything explosive happen.
The air coming in. Yeah, he's going to get... Should have gone into Rekkas for that.
I was going to say, if you just went into EX Rekkas, he dies on chip as long as he doesn't parry it.
Yeah.
Now, is there a notion of, like, if you block the low forward and don't parry it, is there a concept of things jailing where, like, you block the first hit so you can't parry the rest of them, or can you block a thing and then transition to the parry?
Okay, well, Yang can change his timing with his Rekkas.
Okay, sure.
So it's...
so it's not the easiest thing to just, like, block the low forward and then be like, oh, but I'll parry the Rekkas. Like,
yeah, no, it depends. Like, the EX Rekkas, you can change the timing of those significantly. The regular Rekkas are a little bit more predictable. You can parry the second Rekka and the third Rekka pretty easily. If you get the low forward blocked and do just one Rekka, you're safe. After that second Rekka, Ken can punish it. Sean can punish it. Anybody with a zero frame super can punish it.
I see. Okay.
So you went for two there. If that was Ken could have punished it with super.
All right.
Weird time to go for Sanibu. Gets knocked down. It's probably going to be a waste of it.
Okay. There's the unblockable mirror.
Boy, looked him the other way. Nice throw. Urian's got arguably the best normal throw in the game.
In terms of just the damage on it?
No, just the range and just because of what it does for his setups.
I see. Oh, because it leaves him in a good spot.
It's really hard to quick rise from. Not really hard, but mildly hard. Nice parrying.
Wow, that mirror lasts a long time.
Yeah, it does.
I'm used to the Street Fighter V mirrors.
Gootecks.
Nice job. Nice escape from the corner by Gootecks.
Yeah. Okay. Gets a game on the board for himself, does Gootecks.
All right, so we're at 1-1.
He's trying to disappoint you. He's looking to guarantee himself a spot in top four.
Yeah?
Every win brings him closer to disappointing you, making you sad for our community.
I'll just leave. I'll just walk I'll walk right out the front door.
So set point now. Wow, that was a trade. Yang lost so much life.
Yeah, he did, yeah. Constant pressure from the Sinibu. Good escape from the corner. That was a risky teleport. Unlike a Thuma's teleport, a Yang's teleport is very punishable.
Okay.
Nuke's grab.
Oh, that's going to be punishable, yeah?
Yep.
Yeah.
Goes into Sinibu. No, makes a good use of Sinibu.
It seems like he's only really had one great activation on it.
That's why you don't see Sinibu so much. You usually see SA2. It's not even for the super, it's for the bar. It's get more EX markers.
Okay, sure. Because you can hang on to more super meter.
Nice tackle. Gets the corner throw. Quick rise. Nice parry from Cosby. Putting the pressure on. He should have kept on that pressure, I think. Let's see what he can do here with the Sinibu. Yep. Here we go. Get the kick combo into Rekkas. That's beautiful.
Wow.
Doesn't do a whole ton of damage, but it's a small meter. He's throwing out some really good jabs, Cosby. Did you see what I'm talking about with that throw?
Yeah, the mirror ends up right on him, and then there's the unblockable.
Yep. All because of that throw.
All right, so set point both players now.
Oh, you could have got something off that if he converted off the Standing Fierce trade.
That's interesting. Was he poking the mirror to get rid of its durability?
Yep, you can do that. Yeah, you can shorten the lifespan of the mirror by essentially hitting it.
Interesting.
Yep. Can't do that in five?
No.
No?
You'll die.
You die. Yeah. As long as you're only hitting the hitbox on it, you're good.
Yeah, so, that's how you lose games in Street Fighter V.
Yeah, wow. So that was won by Gootecks.
Yeah, so that sets him up in the top four. Let me double check. I'm going to hope that the bracket was updated with what had gone on the other side. I don't recall if Everdred or Furious Roy had won their loser side match. Everdred did, so that sets up Gootecks and Everdred. Who sent Gootecks to losers? Everdred.
Wow, how about that?
There's a reason that I checked. It's because the matchup sounded familiar.
So that sends Gootecks to losers round six. He will play the winner of...
I think...
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
so
they already played, so...
Yeah, they just played, so that means it's going to be Gootecks versus Shotokan.
Oh, Gootecks Everdred, right?
Because
Shotokan is waiting in losers finals.
You're right. You are absolutely right. My mistake.
Me or him?
I'll switch.
Oh, I can if you want. I can if you want. It's not a hard question. You want to switch with me?
I just couldn't hear you.
Yeah, all right. I'll be back in a little while. You're being handed back to Furious Roy.
Maybe Furious Roy can shed some light on the situation.
And we're back.
We are back.
Furious Roy here.
I thought you played admirably.
Thank you. I don't think I performed well today. I wish I did better. Honestly, I'm just kicking myself in the butt for losing to Cosby. So close. I almost had him.
But how about Stuffy, though?
But, I mean, we go back. And Stuffy took me to fucking match point two or something. I don't know. Stuffy was really strong. Stuffy's scary. Yeah, you, when I face Stuffy in tournament, it's pretty close these days.
Yeah, yeah. He's progressed so much.
You're right, yeah.
He really has.
Pretty crazy.
He's got some really strong Hugo tech.
Yeah, you don't want to be in the corner versus him, man.
No, no. He's got that whiff move that he does, and then it's just a guess.
He's got a bag of tricks.
Yeah.
We've got a rematch here. They spelled Everdred wrong.
Yo, guys, you spell Everdred is Everdredd. Redd. No A. Two D's.
Just get rid of the A.
Yeah, just get rid of the A, make it a D. I just want these guys to be represented.
No, not two D's at the end. Just get rid of that last D. Just get rid of that last D.
The last thing you should have to worry about right now is having enough toilet paper. Please know we're working around the clock to get you more Charmin. Stay safe.
When smartphones are expensive, the family has to share one. Step up with Boost Mobile and get four phones for free. Switch to Boost Mobile and get four lines for $25 per line with unlimited data and four free Samsung Galaxy A20 phones, all on our super fast network.
1D.
1D at the end.
All right, let's get back to the important stuff at hand. This is a rematch. Everdred put gootecks into loser's bracket.
Here he is. Getting a lot of mileage off that.
In danger of the double jeopardy. He's got some mix-ups going on right now. Good throws. This is a tough matchup for Urien, actually, and a pretty nice one for Red. Urien is big. He doesn't have a lot of ways of getting in.
But
he definitely did right there.
Remy has not very much life.
Really? He's got a short life bar?
I'm pretty sure, yeah.
Maybe
somebody in the chat can correct me on that.
Everdred's got to hit gootecks a lot more than gootecks has to hit him, that's for sure.
Yeah, agreed.
But
gold blue kick and the flash kick.
As you can see, he gets a lot of those. The pressure is tough to deal with. Those kicks are fast. The dive kicks are fast. Hard to deal with those sonic booms. But Gutex is burning meter just to get close to it. And we're even now. Gootecks is liking those knee drops. He did three in a row. The third one never works, by the way.
Yeah.
The third one never works. Just down back. Gootecks is known for doing that down back and then headbutt throw in the corner. No punish on the sweep, double sweep. Lots of little pokes.
That's
could have killed him right there, but yeah.
Nice.
See, it's just you want to jump in and parry. Gootecks is rolling his eyes because he missed the parry.
He's an emotional player. He plays with his emotions on his sleeve for sure.
Yeah, you can tell. Look at him. His head is down.
Last time we saw that happen, he came back and won, I believe. So
this is three. Is this? No, wait, no.
This is not losing.
Two out of three.
Yeah,
this
is two out of three. The winner of this will face Shotokan for losers finals.
Gootecks needs a second to think. Shaking his head, he's like, I'm not gonna lose to this guy. What you don't know is Everdred's a fucking strong player, and there's no shame in losing to this guy. Nice tackles. Tackles a good way for Urien to get in on this matchup, but you always run the risk of running into a sonic boom or whiffing right there.
No, this ain't your daddy sonic boom.
Ooh.
Just goes
plus,
for it.
That's plus.
Yeah, just plus. Yeah, you're right.
Somehow he's getting mileage off these knee drops.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, he got
the cross. Oh, that was a pretty good, yeah.
Nice ping pong.
Yeah. Very good ping pong.
Gootecks likes making use of that. Random headbutt, knee drop knockdowns. Get him in a little Aegis if they don't quick rise. It could be hard to quick rise against Urian.
I said that last time.
It can be tough.
It really can be, yep. Especially online.
Yeah, especially online. And if you don't quick stand against Urian, he's going to get a ghetto unblockable against you.
Ghetto unblockable.
Punish the headbutt.
It's the neutral super jump. I'm sure what that was about.
Oh.
Nice parry. He's gonna get...
Imagine if he got the glitch.
Yeah.
Imagine if he got the glitch.
Yeah.
Does that mean he wins if he gets the glitch?
I don't know.
We're at match point, guys. Everdred is scary,
he
man.
Is.
Look at this guy come at you.
Here
big
he goes.
Jumping combo nice over the
combo.
Fireball.
Gets the
throw
grab.
Right
gets
in the
face. Grab.
Getting good mix-ups.
Yes,
mileage. Nice overhead. Big poke.
Yeah, he's got a pull for the
did not there. Throw him in the corner. That was a mistake.
Oh, nice song.
He's trying to parry now. Gootecks is desperate. He needs some miracle.
That could have been funny.
Yeah, this is going to be tough. Nice text.
EX on boom. He's just...
Oh, shit.
That's
he's
it.
Got the juice.
So that looks like Gootecks.
Gootecks accepts defeat. No shame in losing to this guy. He's a fucking... Look, I predicted top three would be Everdred, Shotokan, Ken. What do we got here?
I think we got...
That's it?
I think that's what we got.
That's the top three.
So
we're
now...
the losers, Matt. Losers, losers finals. Everdred's feeling the... pressure right now, I could tell. A little bit nervous. Looks like we got our boy Shotokan, number one Yoon, I would say, on the East Coast.
I would say so, too. I'd like to give a shout out to Shotokan, who really ushered me into Third Strike. He, when I first started playing, he was one of the first people I played, one of the first people to give me advice. I started off as a young main, and he took me under his wing a little bit, and we still talk about tech to this day.
Shotokan will do that. He's that type of guy. If you want to learn Third Strike, he will teach you.
Just find him on Discord. He'll be more than happy
Discord,
to talk with
you. Twitter, reach him.
He's got a very, very good Twitter going.
Reach out to him if you want. He's always trying to discover new young techs. He's always striving as a player to get better, and it shows. 10 years ago, we used to joke around about Shotokan. Look at him now. He's fucking killing guys.
Sometimes that's what it takes.
Yeah, very impressive. He's come a very long way. I believe he got first or second at a major last season.
Yeah.
Big one.
I forget which one that was. I'm going to switch out.
Oh, we got Brad in here. I am easily confused.
I just confused the shit out of Roy because I was like, oh, you went back so I could walk in front rather than going forward so I could walk him back.
I don't know, but we're back.
Yeah, we're back. We're at top three.
Yeah, we made it. It's been a long night.
Yeah. Shotokan and Everdred, losers finals.
Yeah. This is 3 to 5. Now.
We are almost at the prophesized grand finals.
Yeah, I saw this one coming. I seeded Shotokan first. We expected to see these guys in the finals. Big Ganesian combos coming out from Shotokan. Everdred is going for... He's trying to go for damage right now. He needs something big. He's trying to get launchers. He's trying to look for anything.
So, I had asked a little bit earlier, but I'm noticing it again with the dive kick characters. Is it hard to get combos off jump-ins in this game?
Off the dive kick, you have to hit
I assume it's you have to hit, like, at
hit
the floor.
Very low. below the knee. But he's got all kinds of mix-ups off those dive kicks.
Sure, I mean, if it lands, you're plus.
He can cross you up. He can dive kick again, mess with people who are mashing on throw. So basically, if you let him dive kick in on you, prepare to block, prepare to guess. He gets in. Super, so cheap.
Wow.
Overhead into the combo. Good at that. Oh, wow. Got him out of the corner somehow. He dashed through it.
And baits the uppercut.
That's
gets
tough.
The super off of it. He just had it.
Yeah.
The meter build is ridiculous.
How many times did he pop super?
Twice in that round. In that round.
Yeah, that's fair.
Taking the first game. This is 3 out of 5.
That was a fast one.
Something else I'm noticing, I feel like Shotokan pumps forward for the parry on wake up a fair bit. Like, he has a really great read on when they're going to try to meaty him and gets the parry through it all.
Shotokan likes to wake up parry. Throw him on wake up.
I don't know this game, and I'm seeing it. It's coming up so much.
He likes that. He likes that. That's his go-to. If he's not waking up parry, he's waking up.
Again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Did he just shoulder through Remy's reversal too?
Yeah, that does go through shit. It goes under shit.
With the shoulder low profile?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
No wonder Shay. His hitbox is very low to the ground. Like his brother Yang when he does the roll kick.
I imagine he doesn't want to spend the bar here if he can avoid it. Spends the bar on an uppercut in hopes of not using the super. Health pretty similar here.
Shotokan likes to pop that shit when he's low. Not a good use of meter in this case.
Yeah, ends up blowing his whole bar there to not secure the round. Walk under on the neutral jump though against Everdread.
See how he can continue that momentum with those kicks. He's in, he's out.
And he's got super again already.
It's ridiculous. That bar is small. Not gonna get a lot of damage, but a little bit.
So in that situation, it was low forward super. He doesn't get a guaranteed follow-up if he does that?
No.
Okay, so it's a mix. Okay.
So let's say Yun does land the low forward. He's got to basically, on counter hit, he will have enough hit stun to continue a combo.
Okay.
But normally, if the range is wrong, you won't be able to connect that.
Okay.
It is plus, though, so even if you block the low forward and he activates, he's going to get to press the next spot.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. And Everdred takes that one, huh?
Yeah, he did manage to clinch it out.
Good shit. That sweep has got a lot of range. The second one goes further than the first. If you're quick, if you see it, though, you can just parry that second hit if you want.
Oh, there's that throw on wake up.
Everdred getting a lot of damage in really quickly. What? He eats a Cloaking Agent combo.
Yeah, this is going to be big damage. Does he go for what's the mix-up situation afterwards?
He
tries to bait the uppercut?
And we're even again. Wow.
Ooh, okay.
Wow. I'm going to go on a whim and say that was actually just a guess parry, but it worked out really well.
Shoulder Ganagin. Hit by the overhead, nothing after
not
it, though.
Not at all. Good shit.
Okay.
They meet in the air. Nothing much happens.
He's the only person I've seen today parry the low fireball at the EX fireball in that range.
The EX fireball from Remy is really hard to parry. That they move in such a way that the first one can hit you, and then like a little bit later, the second one hits you.
Sure. Yeah, no, I've seen a lot of people struggling with dealing with the second shot.
Yeah, basically, if Emmerdred catches you just parrying those sonic booms, he's gonna throw that at you, and it's gonna mess you up. It's gonna mess your timing up. You're probably gonna get hit by it really fast.
Yeah, so Shotokan on set point here, if he's able to win this game, up 2-1 over Evergood. This is Losers Finals. Jazzy Circuit points on the line.
Yeah, we almost had a 400-point tournament. We were one man away. Tragic. It was almost 20 people out there. Big tournament. We do not have a big scene out here. So for us to get this many people to come out on a Friday night, very nice.
Yeah, no, a couple of people from New York came out.
Evergreen is from Maine. Took him 2 hours to get here.
Jeez, that's a hike.
Yeah, people are traveling out.
That's awesome. It's a big weekend for it. It's a big weekend for retro games, obviously.
Yeah, those New York players, that's a four-hour bus ride. They're all staying with Locust tonight. Locust is putting them up for the night. They traveled out here, need a place to stay.
That was actually sick. The shallow dive kick to bait an overhead into the shoulder on landing.
Oh yeah, this guy's got a huge bag of tricks. He will mix you up. Shotokan's strategy is not if it ain't broke, don't fix the strategy. Whereas you find someone's weakness and you use it over and over against them. This guy will just mix you up all day. He'll never do the same thing twice.
Oh, magic pixel here for Everdread, but get clipped by the low forward.
There it is, yep. Shotokan feeling good. Should be staying. Hopefully he's ready for this rematch.
Now, Ken and Black was playing Dudley, yes.
Very good.
I didn't phrase that yes like a question, but it was a question.
Very good Dudley player coming out of New York. Top player. By far, this guy's been playing in tournaments since he was 12 years old, and he's still a young gun, about 19, 20 years old, basically a veteran at this point.
And that's crazy to think about him.
Yeah, he's got the reactions, he's got the youth, yeah, and, yeah, I mean, he's used to playing in tournaments, you know? He's been here before.
Yeah. And so what about Shotokan? He's local, yes?
Shotokan is from Rhode Island.
Okay.
He's a very old
We'll call that
player.
Local. We'll call that local.
Yeah. He came here from Rhode Island. Shout out to Rhode Island. Shotokan. Ill Will. Cosby. You guys did great tonight. Ill Will is going to be playing Justin Wong in the exhibition.
Yeah. I got confirmation of that from Dan earlier, and that's who I wanted to see. I was like, man, I hope we're able to get, like, Ill Will or something out. Dan's like, Ill Will's going to play Justin. I'm like, all right. Okay.
Yeah,
I'm ready.
Sick at Marvel. They've been playing since it came out. Pretty much.
I haven't seen Ill Will since he smoked me in a vanilla Marvel 3 tournament at Super Bowl.
Yeah, he moved down to Florida and he is back and back with a vengeance. Playing a lot of Marvel.
Ooh, this is going to be big damage though. I expect that we're going to need a
Keeper,
reset of some kind though if he wants to make this happen.
Yeah, that's not going to kill.
Oh my. Oh, the low forward.
Wow.
Okay, empty jump uppercut. That was almost so sick from Shotokan, though. He really almost made that happen. The low forward clipping the corkscrew.
Yeah, that was amazing. The good stuff on the corkscrew. I thought that was going to be a good reversal. But Ken in Black likes that empty jump. Assure you, that thing comes in clutch. Good tool to have in your arsenal. Sometimes you got to play crazy.
Isn't able to follow up the combo. Empty jump low!
Yeah, Dudley is hard to combo. He falls fast. He's a fat character.
Dudley.
Dudley, sorry.
Okay.
Dudley, he's got a weird hitbox, yeah. So you have very character-specific combos on him.
Nice read from Ken and Black there.
Good damage. Big mix-up. Good hit confirms.
Oh, text the rose, but still gets clipped. First game going to Ken and Black.
Yikes.
That's that wake up parry, like once again.
Yeah, it didn't work out for him. You wake up parry against Ken, he's going to mix you up. 9 times out of 10 you lose that battle. Go for it. Guys are feeling each other out now. They don't want to go in too hard. Waiting for a meter.
Okay, gets the command grab.
Yep. Hard command grab.
Now, it's interesting. I don't know if Shotokan approached the winner's finals in this way. Or perhaps I just didn't notice. But Shotokan backing off. And if he doesn't have Ganagen, he's playing Wicked Lame and he's backing off. He doesn't want to go in unless a hit is going to lead to big damage.
Yep. Yeah, he's a very risk-reward type of player. If it comes down to this, yeah, he's going to run away on your ass and build Ganagen meter.
Because it's not what I feel like we just saw him doing in other matchups.
No, he was more confident in those matchups. This, he needs to play textbook to fuck this out. He needs to play lame. He needs to abuse his character.
Yep, backing straight off.
But Dudley has all the tools to beat Shotokan and do big damage.
Oh, doesn't go into the Ganagen off that low forward, but just activates. Oh, clips by the hair of the dive kick.
Not going to do enough damage.
Oh, the command grab again.
Wow, all right, we're back. And we're even.
That was damn near two consecutive command grabs there from Shotokan to take out that game. That's going to be something that Ken and Black's going to have to get wise to. In that first game, it looked like at one point in a situation where there was the command grab, we did see that short hop come up from Ken and Black. So it is something he was previously mindful of. I wonder if he's going to be paying more attention to it going forward.
Let's see. This guy adapts very quickly. Oh, he could have got bigger damage off that, but he drops it.
Oh, doesn't get the palm.
For some reason, it whiffs.
Ooh!
Right. Yeah, got him out of the corner.
Okay, almost with punish. Yeah, Shotokan is one nice confirmer, one nice Ganagen combo away from getting a kill here.
Looks like he's burning a lot of meter, but he gets something off of it.
Yep, by the last hit.
Those last hits do big damage because of scaling ends. Those enders are good.
Ooh, okay.
Two hits. Gotta parry it twice. Yep, he's catching him. Ken is trying to fight back against that Ganagen, but that is an uphill battle.
Ooh, nice tech. That's gonna be decent damage. Makes his way out of the corner.
Good mix-up. I think Shotokan's trying to wake up parry again.
Wake up DP that time.
Yep, does it again.
Ooh, into the EX shoulder. Takes it Shotokan with two games.
All right, well.
Could it be, is he awake? He's awake.
Oh yeah, this guy's awake.
I just want to check my watch to see what time it was, but it's a smartwatch and it's dead, so I don't know what time it is. But Shotokan, it's not past Shotokan's bedtime.
Oh yeah. Go. Ooh. Yep. Both of them being very cautious at the moment. But that Ganagen meter, man, he's always got it.
There's the command grab once again from Ken and Black. That's 3 for 3. We haven't really seen any whiff.
Yep, you want to block against Ganagen? Watch out for that throw. That's twice now. Catches a whiff.
He's going to be damn near dead here.
Oh, yeah. This is a bad spot.
Overhead?
No. Shotokan's looking confident right now. He wants to close this out. Yeah, this guy's controls the air.
Yeah, reset point for Shotokan.
Yeah. This could be it, guys. So much pressure.
Holy. Oh, there's the whiff, but no punish.
No punish. That's hard to punish.
Doesn't look like it whiffs for very long.
It's about 23 frames of recovery. That is about half a second.
Okay, that was such a great read.
Yeah, caught him jumping.
That was it.
Shotokan started blocking that and stopped blocking in the middle. He's being very aggressive. He wants that meter.
Hit by the overhead at the very last second.
Nothing off of it.
Oh yeah, he's gonna run away, isn't he? Yeah. Three Canadians, guys. Nice. Runs into the uppercut.
He's got another one if he's able to get a nice hit confirmed. This could be a really close round. Kenan Black needs to make this happen. No, it's not going to be it. That's the bracket is reset.
Shotokan is the winner, I believe. Oh, wait, no, he has to reset.
He has to reset the bracket.
Oh, wow. Yikes, I forgot that Shotokan got put
in. It is second impact.
Wow. All right.
The Shin Grand Finals.
Wow, this is great.
Taking it all the way to the end. Once again, quick reminder, it's approaching the last opportunity, but make sure you guys check out that Matcharino.
Yeah.
Salad3S is the Matcharino code to put 50 cents in. One of these two players is going to be able to reap the benefits of that.
Yeah, support Third Strike, guys. It's a great game. Play Third Strike.
Big damage in the corner. Gets the forward throw. A little bit of space for himself for Shotokan. Back throw right back into the corner. No punish on the whiff there. Yeah. I feel like Kenan Black needs to maybe a little bit of sleep at the wheel there.
Yeah, he's a little bit afraid of that Ganesian. It's just so fast. It's really hard to see what's going to be coming at you. 9 times out of 10, it's better to just down back and eat that throw because it does a lot less damage than a full Ganesian combo.
Nice back sway there. Ooh, into another great confirm.
And gets the low short super.
Ooh, okay.
Kenan Black does not want to lose.
That was a clean game.
That was good. Shotokan needs to recollect himself a little bit here.
Yeah, I feel like he was doing really well when he was able to slow it down there. I wonder if maybe Kenan Black has sort of found the right way to answer that pace.
Yeah, you can't rush this, Shotokan.
Ooh, what a read! That's another. Shotokan's been really jumping around a lot, using sort of the variant jump arcs and the dive kicks to really justify or really make his movement very tricky. It seems like Kenan Black, maybe that's sort of the big adjustment, is that Kenan Black has a better sense of how Shotokan is moving.
He also seems to know how to mix them up right now. Tries to get him with
full
throws. That was creative.
Finally blowing up the command grab, though, with that up back.
Yeah, we're seeing Shotokan wake up here.
Ooh, the back sway on wake up. Second game, quick and easy. Kenan Black, reverse download complete.
On the rebound.
How many seeds on that torrent?
Yeah. We got some downloads. Download fast. Fast downloads.
Yo, was that 100 up, 100 down?
Yeah. Fast internet connections.
So after that first set, Shotokan now down 2 games.
Shotokan is sweating.
This is much more reminiscent of the winner's finals.
Yeah, it was close.
You know what maybe part of it is? Shotokan played like 3 sets back to back. Kenan Black had to sit back down and get warm again. Maybe that's just what it took.
Yeah, that is a factor.
There we are. Big damage here from Shotokan. First really great round for Shotokan, or ground start at least for Shotokan, since the bracket reset.
Third of his health right there.
Ooh, jabbed out of his wake-up reversal.
Yeah.
I can see Dan just stood up in his seat and pointed at the screen to someone else on the other end of the room. Like, you see that shit? Tournament point for Kenan Black. Coming for those Jazzy Circuit points.
Yeah. I know Bunch GG is going to talk a lot of shit, but the reality of the situation, Boston Third Strike was never better than New York and probably never will be.
Whoa. You got to have faith in your boy. He needs the Spirit Bomb right now.
Have my energy, Shotokan. I want you to win, but I'm a realist. The Rose.
No, doesn't attempt to parry the Rose that time.
It.
That's going to do it.
That's it. Tragic.
Reverse download complete. Bunch already walking through the venue, clapping.
Very close. Yeah, he's happy that his friend won.
On some, like, Bunch walked up to Dan and was like, New York is guaranteed at least second place in the Boston Third Strike Tournament. And I looked at Bunch and I said, is this your first time having somebody from out of town come to a Boston tournament?
It is. That is, yeah.
What, for Bunch? Because what I'm getting at is whenever anybody from out of town comes to a Boston tournament from, like, a real scene,
no,
they always make it deep.
Yeah, this is the first time we've actually had people travel out.
For a third strike.
Third strike tournament. Yeah, we were when 30th came out, 2018, yeah, for about 6 months we ran consistent tournaments. Every Friday we had some monthlies. Just kind of fell off. Once we only had three people for tournaments, I was kind of like, guys, maybe we should just play casuals. So this was the resurgence. This was us really trying hard to get as many people out here, and it was a big success. Tonight was great.
Yeah, I mean, it was really awesome. Once again, shout-outs to the team behind Jazzy Circuit for putting the points behind this event.
Mutant XP, thank
yeah,
you.
And the New York crew for coming through for PAX. Gootecks for
deciding
to show up and play.
Gootecks, celebrity host, B-list celebrity.
So
we're gonna be closing this one out.
I have one more person to thank, and it's you and Gootecks and Locust for carrying me through my lack of third strike knowledge of the night. But it's been really fun getting exposed to this game.
Ah, you're a pro at
this. It's just the game is just shy of my time.
It's
when I get insight into it, it's always super sick.
It's a fun game to watch.
It's really cool.
Especially at a high level.
And it's the pace of it and just the way that the neutral plays out is so different.
And it's a beautiful game. Look at those sprites.
It is. That's one of the things. I remember when 4 came out. When 4 came out, I had this thing, slight detour. Before I got into Fighters, I was big into RTS. I loved StarCraft. I loved StarCraft Brood War.
I love StarCraft.
When StarCraft 2 came out, I was like, man, I feel like you lose something by going from the sprites to the 3D. And when Street Fighter 4 came out and all my buddies were playing Street Fighter 4, we had a main cabinet, and I was like, yeah, but look at Third Strike. Like, this is beautiful. It took me a little while to get used to that 3D thing. But, yeah, the sprite work is fantastic.
Yeah. 3D, fake 2D, 2D slash 3D.
2.5D.
Get your hand off my wife's ample but firm backside.
I'm becoming stronger.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Coworkers die. Vampire roommates, they're forever.
What We Do in the Shadows. All new Wednesdays at 10 on FX. Now streaming FX on Hulu.
Gordon Hayward shows his opponents no mercy. No, seriously. He's like ridiculously competitive. Which is why he refuses to play on anything but gamer-grade internet from Xfinity.
5D. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
But
we're
so
living
I think
between dimensions.
But I think that we are wrapping up for the evening. Thanks once again, everybody.
It's been real.
For watching. If you're on the Cross Counter channel, because we were dual streaming, if you would be so kind, if you liked what we did tonight, please follow Traveling Controller on Twitch and on Twitter. We are here every Friday. Not me personally, but everyone else here is here every Friday, bringing you Street Fighter, Dragon Ball FighterZ, Tekken. We've got a bunch of stuff for you. So make sure you follow Traveling Controller to always be up to date on everything with that. If you want to follow me, I'm @its_BradM on Twitter. This is @FuriousRoy.
@FuriousRoy, yeah.
And y'all know Gootecks. If you're in the Traveling Controller chat, you probably know about Cross Counter and Gootecks, so I don't need to plug them. But I will plug on behalf of Gootecks. Bar Fights is tomorrow, so if you are in town, Bar Fights Boston is tomorrow night from 5 to 10 p.m. The
big
event
exhibition matches.
Yeah, there's you said earlier with Ill Will and Justin and Marvel
Wong.
2.
Yep.
There's a bunch of other events that we're running too, including a Street Fighter 5 tournament that I believe is a service members tournament with the armed forces, if I'm not mistaken. So that'll be
support
cool.
The troops.
We're gonna have some Uniclear, Grand Blue, Dragon Ball. It's a bunch of stuff is gonna be there. So make sure you come and hang out. It's gonna be a really good time. Gootecks is gonna be there. Cross Counter team gonna be there. J Wong, K Brad. Kizzy K, I think, is going to be here.
Big names.
So it'll
Famous
be really
players.
Fun. Thanks, guys, for hanging out.
It's been tonight. Real, guys. Thank you. Play Third Strike. It's a good game.
The meme. You ended on the meme.
You know.
Okay.
Shout out to Rom.